Well, hi everybody, and a tremendous Tuesday evening to you as we come your way from Paramount High School as the Babe Herman tournament continues between the Nitros and the Pirates of Paramount. We are sitting here waiting to start the game as the managers have the meetings with the umpires at the plate, and we're hoping that the rain stays away so that we can bring you the baseball game here tonight. So if we happen to disappear right away, it's because the rains came and I don't want to get fried. So again, we're here at Paramount taking on the Pirates. The Nitros coming off a 10-0 loss to San Dimas last night, and so they will look to get back into the win column against the Pirates. The two teams were scheduled to play last year, but we got down here and the rains came and it got rained out after about an inning and a half of play. So hopefully we can get this one in. Let's go ahead and take a look at the starting lineups. First off, for the visiting Nitros, they come into the contest with a record of 2-4-1, coming off that 10-0 loss last night. Leading things off, playing second base, number 7, Davin Edom. Hitting second, behind the plate, number 12, Nolan Wong. At short, hitting third, number 16, Darian Jenks. Batting fourth, doing the pitching, number 33, Thomas Kovarik. Hitting fifth in left field, number 1, Ethan Aldretti. Batting sixth at third base, number 22, Nate Rangel. Hitting seventh at first base, number 3, Trent Lucherarian. Hitting eighth in right field, number 6, Mike Titchener. And batting ninth in center field, number 15, Adrian Cole. For the Pirates, defensively, they will stack up this way from left to right in the outfield. Omar Padilla, Joshua Burgos, and Raimundo Medina. From third to first across the infield, Robert Mendez, Adrian Bautista, Edgar Sanchez, and Michael Poot. Behind the plate, Chris Rivera, and up on the mound, Gabriel Olguin. The Pirates come into the contest with a record of 1-7. They defeated Pasadena yesterday by a score of 3-2 for their first victory of the season. They opened up the season with a loss to San Juan Hills, 2-1 in 8 innings, fell to La Habra, 12-1, lost to Yucaipa, 6-2, fell to Long Beach Poly, 7-4, Sunny Hills got them 6-2, Murrieta Valley won 4-2, and they lost to Crescent Valley, 5-2, before that victory over Pasadena, 3-2. So this is their third consecutive game against the Pacific League, and I guess for them it's the rubber match as they're 1-1 so far. You look back at their record against the Pacific League, they're 1-1 against Pasadena. They played this year and last year. They won 3-2 this year, lost 3-2 last year to the Bulldogs. Then they played Burroughs, and also a 1-1 mark against them, having lost in 2015 but beat them back in 2007. And then CV this year, they're 0-1, losing 5-2. This will be the first matchup that I can tell between Glendale and Paramount. Again, last year where they were scheduled to play in this tournament, but it got rained out. And so the Pirates take the field. We're going to try to get this thing in. And we're glad you're here with us. And you might have the best seat in the house because it took about an hour and a half to get down the 710 freeway to get here to Paramount. So you probably saved yourself a few lives in frustration, a few years of life in frustration. So you've got Gabriel Olguin up on the mound. He is going to be pitching. And again, it looks like this will be his first appearance. Yesterday, the Saints of San Dimas threw a couple of pitchers that did not have any stats in the record books for this year on the mound, and it looks to be the same this year as you have Gabriel Olguin up on the mound. Chris Rivera behind the plate will be your battery. San Gabriel, or the San Gabriel Valley League, is where Paramount resides. Teams include Warren, Dominguez, Gar, Downey, Linwood, and Paramount. Gar has pretty much dominated the league over the last few years. They have 7 league championships. But the Pirates, they've won their fair share. It's been a number of years, but they actually have 4 league championships dating back to the 2005 season. Gar was 7, Downey with 4, and Warren, they were co-league champs last year with Gar. Last year, the Pirates went 12-13-1. The year before that, they were 21-12, going 7-3 in league, finishing second to Gar. So Davin leading things off, trying to get things going for Paramount, or for against Paramount here in Paramount, taking on the Pirates. He's batting .263 on the season. He has 5 hits, 4 singles, and a double. He's been hit by a pitch 4 times. He's also walked 5 times, so he has 9 free passes. Scored 6 runs, has 12 stolen bases on the year, and an on-base percentage of .500. You can also check out the video of the contest on facebook.com/edomrocksradio.com. So you can enjoy the audio broadcast here. Check out the video. It might even be a simulcast if the audio is working correctly. And so Olguin into the windup. And the first pitch of the ball game is taken on the outside, just off the plate. Ball one the count to Edom. He hit 300 last year as a junior. Really put it together in league play, hitting 368. Takes the next pitch low, ball two, 2-0. Had a rough go of it last night. He went 0 for 1 with a strikeout and a walk. The Nitros only had one hit yesterday. It was Titchener with a base hit in his first at-bat. The 2-0 offering, check swing over for a strike. And the count moves to 2-1 the count. Nice complex here in Paramount. Truly is the green cathedral. You've got the green grass. You've got the green outfield fence and a green batter's eye in center field. There's the 2-1 offering. Missing off the mark outside away from the batter. And the count moves to 3-1, so a hitter's count here. David making the pitcher throw some pitches. This will be his fifth pitch upcoming. And hopefully giving the guys on the bench an opportunity to see what kind of pitcher Olguin is. He's ready and delivers the 3-1 offering. Outside ball four, and David draws the walk. So the Nitros get their leadoff hitter aboard. Olguin offering up a walk. And that will bring to the plate Nolan Wong. Good move here by Coach Chan, moving up Wong into the lineup. He's hitting 400. He's 6 for 15 as we have a conference on the mound. He has 6 singles. He's driven in 3. He's walked 3 times, couple strikeouts. Batting 400 on the season. Has an on-base percentage of .474. So trying to stack the lineup here with Edom, Wong, and Jenks, and then giving Kovarik the pitcher maybe an opportunity to help his cause should he get some runners on. So Edom taking his lead away from first, being held on by Poot. A throw over to first, not in time as Damon dives headfirst back into the bag. Game just underway, top of the first inning. Leadoff hitter aboard for the Nitros. Glad to have you along. Son Edom, Stuart Edom with you from Paramount. The pitch swung on, fouled back. Nothing and one the count to Nolan. He is the catcher. Will be working behind the plate. And as it stands, the only catcher that we've seen, well, we did see Seth Harley behind the plate a little bit in the Desert Christian game when Nolan was out with an injury. The pitch, there goes the runner, the pitch out, the throw down to second, and they got him. No, he missed the tag. Well, the throw was there on the pitch out. They guessed right, did the Pirates, but the throw was on the shortstop side of the bag, and Dave able to slide in, and he has his 13th stolen base of the season. 13 for 13 on the year. And so now an RBI opportunity for Nolan with a runner at second base. Looking for his fourth RBI of the season. Davin with his lead away from second. Bluffs takes a big lead. Pitch outside. So Rivera with a good throw down to second base. But again, just off the mark. We've seen that a few times throughout the year. You see the catcher have a strong arm, Nolan included, other catchers. They just throw it down there. But again, it's all the timing and where you put the ball. You just got to let it fly. And hopefully you get it in the right spot. And on that throw, it was on the shortstop side of the bag. And by the time the guy caught the ball, the shortstop, Bautista, catches it and tries to apply the tag. Davin's able to slide in there underneath the tag. The tag was up around the chest. Now we've got another conference. Bautista going to the mound, trying to get on the same page as the pitcher Olguin with that pickoff move. Davin taking a big lead away from second, trying to bait the pitcher into perhaps making a mistake. So Wong at the plate. 2-1 the count. Olguin working from the stretch, turns, and nobody's home. So again, maybe Bautista and Olguin still not on the same page as Olguin at short is going through the motions, and now we've got a timeout as the plate umpire is going over to the Nitros dugout to talk to Coach Chan probably about the cheering that the Nitros are doing. So the game here tonight and then tomorrow, the Nitros are scheduled to play at noon against Summit, but the rains are supposed to come in, and we'll see if they even get that game in. It's supposed to rain at noon overnight, and then it clears up supposedly for a few hours in the morning, but then the rains are supposed to come again at noon tomorrow. This game's a big game to get the Goodyear blimp out there hovering overhead. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Taken outside, ball three, and once again for the second batter in a row, Olguin, 3-1 the count.
Is that Anaheim Stadium?
No. No, isn't Carson over there? And Carson's home for the blimp off the 405 freeway there. Pickoff move to second, not in time. Davin back to the bag, standing up. They should bring it over this way a little bit and put it overhead. Make it sound like it's a big game. And we do try to broadcast the games on Facebook. Swing and a miss by Wong. If you do happen to miss the games, if you go to facebook.com/edenrocksradio.com, we do post them up there. We edit them, and then we repost them so you can watch them. Here's the payoff pitch. Outside, ball four, and Wong draws the walk. So back-to-back walks by Olguin to open up this game, and with two men on, nobody out, Darren Jenks will come to the plate. Now we have a timeout as the manager, the skipper for the Pirates, going to head to the mound and talk to his pitcher. So, yeah, again, we do have a Facebook Live that we do broadcast the games on, facebook.com/edemrocksradio.com, E-I-D-E-M-R-O-C-K-S radio. And then we also broadcast them via the internet live stream at edemrocksradio.com. Or if you just want to be simplified, is you can just go to the Glendale High School Facebook page. We post all the information on the Glendale High School Facebook page where you can find everything. And a special hello to Valerie. How you doing, Valerie? Thanks for helping Davin get through math. He is so relieved he got through his math, and he's done with math now for his high school year. He'll be joining you in the Midwest. I know you're in Pennsylvania, but he will be in Wisconsin, so you guys can commiserate with the cold, although I hear you like the cold, so I'm told from Davin in your conversations. So Davin taking his lead away from second base. Olguin checks the runner at second. Wong away from first. Corners playing in. The pitch on the outside part of the plate at the knees for a strike to Jenks. Nothing and one the count. So Darian coming into the contest, hitting .273. He has 6 hits and 22 at-bats, 5 RBI. He's scored 6 times. He's walked 3 times, stole a couple bases. He has an on-base percentage of .409, and really that's what you want to look at. Kind of like the old money ball, just get on base. Davin bluffs to third, and that will cause Olguin to step off the rubber and take a look back at him. We're in the top of the first inning. The first two batters aboard for the Nitros, Davin with a walk and Nolan with a walk. The corner's playing in, middle infielder's double play depth, about even with the bag. Here's the pitch to the plate, showing bunt, bunts in the air. Catcher Rivera coming back, makes the catch, and we've got one away. So Jenks tried to lay down the bunt in the air, caught by the catcher Rivera, and we've got one away. And that will bring up the pitcher, Thomas Kovarik. Kovarik hitting .250. He's 3-for-12 on the season, has 2 singles and a double. He's driven in 2, scored twice. The team batting average for the Nitros, .251. There goes Davin to third. The throw goes down the left field line. And Davin will come in to score, and the Nitros on the board, 1-0. Was that a pitch to the plate?
Yeah, that was a pitch.
So it was a stolen base?
Yeah,
I was looking at the stats, and next thing I know, you've got a guy going to third and the ball down the left field line. So a stolen base for Davin to third, and then he'll come home on the throwing error by the catcher, and the Nitros lead it 1-0. Wong at second base, as Kovarik now with an RBI opportunity takes a pitch over for a strike, 1-1 the count. So Thomas will be up on the mound for the Nitros. And right now enjoying a 1-0 lead before he throws a pitch. We've got a breeze blowing from right to left. Pickoff moved to second, Wong back to the bag. Sometimes you see pitchers become a different pitcher when a base runner is on. And obviously that might be kind of a duh moment, but oftentimes people don't think about it. You've got a guy that's dealing pitches with nobody on, but once you get that person on, you start distracting the pitcher, and now he has to think about the runner and the batter. It's a different game up on the mound. Pitch over for a strike. Kovarik down in the count now, 1-2. The other thing too is that, you know, the pitching mound, one of the loneliest places to be on the face of the earth. Everybody watching you and the success of your team rides and falls with your arm. The pitch low and away. 2-2 the count. Ethan Aldretti on deck. So Kovarik standing in. 2-2 the count. Wong away from second. Here's the pitch to the plate. Fastball taken high and outside. The count runs full. Now 3-2 to Kovarik. The team batting average for the Nitros, again, hitting .251 on the season. Their on-base percentage is .384. Again, they're doing a little bit better than they have the last couple of years batting. Pitch swung on and fouled off. Coming into the contest, they've played 7 games. They are 2-4-1. And in their first 5 games, in which they went 2-2-1, they've lost their last two, Canyon and yesterday, San Dimas. But before that, the first 5 games, they out-hit all of their opponents. Swinging, there's a ground ball towards second base. Back of the bag, Bautista, the shortstop, bobbles it, and everybody's safe. Throw down to third, but Wong back to the bag. So a slow roller, and Bautista not able to handle it cleanly. And you've got runners at the corners for the Nitros. And that will be the second error of the ball game for Paramount. Again, Paramount, as Ian Nord will come in to run for Kovarik. Nord got into the game yesterday. He got his first hit, a bunt single. Just a sophomore, so he has his first hit under his belt. And now he'll be called upon to run. Yesterday, the Nitros got picked off a couple times. Left-handed pitcher, though, was on the mound. There goes Nord. The pitch taken for a strike. The throw down to second is cut off. And Valerie's listening, too, while watching. Yeah. Felt a raindrop. So Nord with a stolen base as he was going. And again, if we happen to disappear, it's because the rains have come. Breaking ball swung on. There's a drive into left field. Padilla coming in. The ball's going to land in for a base hit. The throw coming to third, not in time. Nord in at third as Wong crosses the plate on an RBI single by Aldretti. And it is 2-0 Nitros here in the top of the first. So Aldretti with an RBI single. He came into the contest hitting .313. That is his second RBI of the season. And runners at the corners for Trent Lucerarian. There goes Ethan down to second base. A no-throw by the catcher. And a stolen base. So runners at second and third now. 2 runs across. Davin led things off with a walk. Nolan then walked. Both of them have since scored. You've got Nord running for Kovarik at third and Aldretti at second after that RBI single. Nate Rangel at the plate. He's 1-for-3 on the year, hitting .333. Fouls that pitch off. Has a 1-ball, 1-strike count. Kevin Chan, into his second season as head coach, went 2-21-1 last year. As the next pitch to Rangel is taken low, 2. Before that, Alan Eberhardt was the coach in his final season, 2016. They went 4-20. Nitros with a couple of wins already as the pitch is high. And the count goes to 3-1 to Rangel. So with 2 wins already in the books, they have an opportunity to perhaps get past the 2 wins, obviously, from last year and maybe the 4 wins from 2 years ago. Pitch is low and away, 4, and the bases are loaded. So the bases are loaded. That will bring up Trent Lucerarian. Trent on the season, hitting .200. He has 3 singles and 15 at-bats. He does have 3 RBI. He scored a couple times. So he has a couple of RBI opportunities here with a runner at third, with the bases loaded, but a runner at third is a realistic RBI opportunity. The infield drawn in. Maybe a base hit scores 2 with Ethan at second. So 2-0 the score. The pitch swung on, fouled back. We do have 1 out. So double play gets you out of it. So the Pirates opting to bring their infield in all the way around as opposed to maybe play the middle infielder's double play depth to try to get a double play ball to get out of it. So defensively, it looks like they're going to come home and try to cut down the run. Here's the next pitch on the way to Trent. Breaking ball, waved at and missed, and Trent down in the count now, nothing and two. Mike Titchener on deck. Titchener with the lone hit yesterday. The Nitros could use a win. They lost to Canyon 17-1, and then yesterday to San Dimas 10-0. So they've been outscored 27-1 in their last two games. The next pitch swung on, fouled at the plate, so Trent up there battling, staying alive. As he looks down to his brother in the third base coaching box, he have his cousin at second base. So he's got a lot of family support cheering him on right now in the same uniform. Here's the 0-2 pitch. Taken outside, ball one. 1-2 to Trent. Trent was the losing pitcher yesterday. Trent kind of gets a raw deal up on the mound because he's the number one pitcher, and so he always faces the toughest opponents. And when the team commits five errors, that doesn't help. And there's strike three on the outside corner, and down goes Trent. So the first strikeout for Olguin. You've got two away, bases loaded for Mike Titchener. So Trent strikes out for the seventh time on the season. And that brings up, like I said, Mike Titchener. Hitting 333, 4 for 12 on the season, has three singles and a double. He's driven in three and scored a couple times. And he takes a pitch high and outside. Now they've got a runner off of first base. Rangel, that they tried to backpick, who was too far away from the bag, but Rangel able to get back in before the tag. And the pitch, ball one. So Titchener with three RBI, looking for more. Had the lone hit of the game yesterday for the Nitros in their 10-0 loss to San Dimas. Here's the 1-0 offering. Taken high, ball two, 2-0. On deck, Adrian Cole. Titchener, the eighth batter to come to the plate here this inning. You always look at common opponents. Not that it really means much, but if Paramount beats Pasadena 3-2, you pull off a victory here. That makes things interesting against Pasadena when you go play them. Although the Bulldogs could be a completely different team by then, as the pitch is over for a strike to Titchener. So two balls, one strike to count, two outs, top of the first inning, 2-0 Nitros on top. They've got the bases loaded. Here's the next offering. Breaking ball swung on and fouled at the plate. And so the count evens at two balls and two strikes. So Olguin trying to get out of it in a bit of a jam. A couple of walks, a base hit, an error, and a few stolen bases contributing to the Nitros' two runs. Here's the pitch. Swinging, there's a fly ball towards second base, a little blooper. Sanchez goes out on the outfield grass, makes the catch, and the inning comes to a close. So F4 on the putout, but for the Nitros, they do pick up two runs. They do that on one hit, a couple errors, and they leave the bases loaded. So we head to the bottom of the first inning after a half an inning here in Paramount. Nitros 2 and the Pirates coming up. And for the Nitros, in that first inning, so far in games now, they've scored 10 runs total. They had 8 coming into the contest, score 2 here. So they have 10 runs scored in the first inning. Their opposition coming into the game have scored 9. So we'll see if they can keep the Pirates from scoring some runs here. The big inning is always the third inning, and it seems to be the fifth inning. This year, the opposition has outscored the Nitros 17-14 in the third inning and then 11-7 in the fifth. So stay tuned because the third and fifth innings have been the innings to watch. Take a look last year. In 24 games, the Nitros were outscored 47-9 in the first game, in the first inning of games. And that kind of tells you the story of last year. And then the fifth inning, if it was close late in the game, they were outscored 20-11. So even though one inning really doesn't make or break a game or a season, when you're outscored 47-9 in the first inning like they were last year, that's going to tell you that you're playing behind and it's a different ball game when you're playing catch-up than when you're playing with the lead compared to this year. Although then yesterday you've got another anomaly because the Saints, they went down in order 1-2-3 in the top of the first inning. Trent was able to shut them down. And then what happens? They come up and score 10 runs and put a whooping on the Nitros. So the breeze starting to pick up, which means the storm's coming in. Although it still doesn't quite look like rain clouds yet. According to the weather forecast, you've got two that I looked at, AccuWeather.com and Weather.com. And, of course, last night you've got all the TV people, Garth Kemp, Fritz Coleman, Jackie Johnson. Pretty much the consensus is the rain's supposed to come in later tonight, maybe 8 o'clock or later. So we should be able to get a good chunk of this game in before the rains come, if not all of it. And then tomorrow, the game for the Nitros is supposed to be at noon Pacific time at home, but that's to be determined based on the rain and field conditions. And then on Saturday, the makeup game from last week with Northview in Covina at 10 a.m. But again, we'll have to see rain, field conditions. The rain's supposed to stop Friday, but if the fields are saturated, it's going to be hard to play. So 2-0 as we head to the bottom of the first inning. And leading things off will be Adrian Bautista, followed by Robert Mendez, and then Raimundo Medina. Koverek up on the mound. And his first pitch, a fastball taken high, ball one. Koverek, he's 0-1. He's 0-1 on the season with an ERA of 4.90. He's pitched in 10 innings, striking out 11, walking 11. Here's the 1-0 offering in there for strike. He's allowed 7 runs, all earned on 7 hits. He's hit 3 batters, and again, he's 0-1 with an ERA of 4.90. So Bautista up there, 1-1 the count. He's hitting 267 on the season, swings and fouls off the first pitch. Actually, now the ball is going to spin back towards fair territory, and the pitcher, Koverek, will come near the foul line, make the catch, and we've got one down. So Bautista hitting 267 is retired, and that brings up Robert Mendez. Mendez hitting 091 on the season. He's pitched or appeared in 4 games. His on-base percentage of 231. He has 1 hit, and that hit came against CV on the 17th of March, St. Paddy's Day, in that 5-2 loss to the Falcons. So Koverek standing in, looking for his first win. He's got a 2-0 lead here in the bottom of the first inning, and the pitch over for a strike to Mendez. 0-1 the count. The opposition facing the Nitros, they've got a team batting average of 246, and their on-base percentage is 397. So the Nitros have a little bit of a better batting average, but Paramount gets on base a little bit more. 1-1 the count to Mendez. Pitch taken high with the fastball. 2-0 here in the bottom of the first inning. The Nitros and the Pirates from Paramount High School, the Green Cathedral in Paramount. There's the 1-1 pitch taken high. One thing we'd like to see from Thomas here is pitch efficiency. A lot of times the Nitros pitching staff, they'll go deep in counts, get a lot of full counts, and then maybe walk the batter or give up a hit or something like that. So you want to see them pitch efficiently, maybe keep the count low. The 2-1 pitch swung on, popped up foul territory, back of the mound. Nolan Wong coming over to try to make a diving attempt near the on-deck circle of the Nitros dugout. Can't quite get there. And so it will be a reprieve for Mendez with a 2-2 count. Raimundo Medina on deck. Mendez has played in 4 games. And again, his lone hit coming against CV. He's reached via the walk a couple times, once against Long Beach Poly and the other against Sunny Hills. That's the 231 batting average. The Pirates coming into the contest hitting 219. They have an on-base percentage of 345. They do have 1 stolen base, and their team ERA is 558. The pitch taken high, and the count goes to 3-2. So full count to Mendez. One hit in 11 at-bats. Here's the payoff pitch from Koverek. Swinging. Again, a foul ball, third base side. Rangel and Wong. The third baseman Rangel is there to make the catch. And we've got 2 outs. So 2 up, 2 down. And that brings up Raimundo Medina. Wearing number 2, hitting 353 on the season. He is tied for the team lead with Peralta, both hitting .353. He has 6 hits and 17 at-bats. He does have an RBI, 2 runs scored, and an extra base hit, 5 singles and a double. Goberic is ready. The right-handed pitcher delivers, and the pitch taken low, ball 1. 1-0 the count to Medina. Nitro's on top, 2-0 here in the bottom of the first inning from Paramount High School. Somewhere tucked away between the 710 freeway and the 105 and south of Southgate. Next pitch taken outside. 2-0 the count. Good crowd on hand. A lot of people from Glendale making the trek. Here's a 2-0 pitch. In there for strike, letter high. So far, the Pirates putting the bat on the ball, but a pop-up to the pitcher and a foul out to the third baseman. So far, it's all they've been able to muster. Here's the next pitch. Low and away, ball 3. So if you're Thomas, you might as well come after him and not give up the walk. You don't want to give up the free passes. That's one thing that the Nitro's pitching staff has been doing this year, is giving up too many free passes. As a team, they've walked 45 and hit 9 batters. Swinging, that's fouled off first base side. First baseman Trent in foul territory, now near the line in fair territory, makes the catch back of first base, and it's a 1-2-3 inning. So the Pirates, they're gone in order. No runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left on. At the end of one, it's 2-0. Nitros, we'll take a break. We'll come back with the second inning right after this.
Arroyo Vista Inn is a historic bed and breakfast centrally located in the hills of South Pasadena, just 15 minutes from downtown L.A. They offer 9 unique rooms with beautiful views, cozy beds, and modern amenities. Enjoy impeccable service, daily breakfast, and afternoon refreshments. All rates include breakfast, parking, Wi-Fi, and tax. Check them out on the web at arroyovistainn.com or call them at 323-478-7300. Are you in the market for real estate services? Then you need Michelle Downing. Michelle combines years of experience and knowledge to get the job done right. Michelle Downing is a founding partner of Partners Trust Real Estate in Pasadena. Whether buying or selling, you need Michelle Downing. She will help you find the residence that is perfect for you. Call Michelle at 626-696-4848. Check her out on the web at thepartnerstrust.com.
Speed Pro Imaging specializes in larger-than-life graphics and can provide you with the highest quality graphic design and print.
So back here at the Green Cathedral in Paramount, as the Nitros take a 2-0 lead to the second inning. Son Edom with you, along with Stuart Edom, here on EdomRocksRadio.com, also on Facebook.com with our live stream, video stream, that is. So Adrian Cole leading things off, followed by the leadoff hitter David Edom, and then Nolan Wong. Cole with a great defensive catch in the game against San Dimas yesterday, takes the first pitch low, ball 1. Trying to look back at other stats, but yeah, looks like Olguin, this might be his first appearance pitching, as Cole is 0-for-5 on the season with 5 strikeouts. Next pitch taken low, ball 2. He does have a walk, so he's 1-for-6 when it comes to on-base percentage, a .167 average. A couple stolen bases as he was a pinch runner one time and got a couple bags. Next pitch, low and away, ball 3, so 3-0 the count. Here's a 3-0 offering. In the plate, in the dirt in front of the plate, ball 4, and Cole is aboard via the walk. That is the 4th walk offered up by Olguin, and that brings up the leadoff hitter, David Edom. He walked, stole a couple bases, and scored his first time up. So his on-base percentage was .500 coming into the contest, so it will go up. That was his 5th walk of the season. It's been a few games since he's gotten a hit. Started out with a 4-game hit streak, had 2 hits against Desert Christian, swings at the first pitch, and he sends a fly ball towards right center field. The center fielder is over there in the gap, makes the catch. Burgess puts it away, and Davin is retired. Kind of an interesting at bat. You just had a pitcher throw four straight balls and you swing at the first pitch. So one down, runner at first for Nolan Wong. He walked, stole a base, and scored in the first inning, the second run of the ball game. 2-0 Nitros in the second inning. Olguin working from the stretch, and the pitch, missing outside, ball one. So 1-0 the count to Wong, moving up in the lineup. Was hitting around fifth or sixth, and now he's up to second. The pitch low and away, there goes Cole. The throw down to second. In time, and they've got him. Nice throw by Rivera from behind the plate. Throw is right there on the money, and Cole is retired. 2-6 on the put out. We've got two down and a 2-0 count to Wong. Here's the 2-0 offering. Swing and a miss, chasing one low and away. Two balls, one strike to count. So Cole walks, he's retired, trying to steal second. Davin flies out to center field, and Wong at the plate with a two-ball, one-strike count. Here's the next pitch. Breaking ball across on the outside part of the plate for strike two. Two balls, two strikes the count. Nolan, the third of three brothers to come through this Glendale Nitro program. Here's the 2-2. Low and away, and the count runs full, 3-2. His brother Bryce, shortstop last year, senior, graduated. Nolan, a junior, so he has another year ahead of him after this one. Olguin looking to get out of it. Here's the payoff pitch. Swinging, pop foul, first base side. That's back out of play. Heads toward the football field. So the count remains full, three balls and two strikes. We've got two away here in the top of the second inning. Nitro's right now enjoying a 2-0 lead. Son Edom with you from Paramount High School, along with Stuart Edom. And the next pitch, taken high, ball four. And the Pirates, they were heading off the field thinking that was going to be called strike three. So Wong reaches for the second consecutive time with a walk. That is the fifth walk offered up by Olguin. And that brings up Darian Jenks. And now Nord will go run for Wong. Probably good getting Nord running because maybe then he'll get tired and go to bed and keep the other kids off the video games. They're up all night playing video games, some of these players. Throw to first, not in time, Nord back to the bag. Remember the day when you played video games, if you're a parent, and you actually had to go over to somebody's house and play the video games? Now you just play them online. Pitch in the dirt. One ball. The count. So Jenks up there, he tried to lay down a bunt and fouled it off, and the catcher Rivera made the catch for the first down to that first inning. He's up there now with a runner on at first with two away in the top of the second. Here's the next pitch. Swinging, there's a one hopper towards short. Nice stop by Batista. And now we've got what a balk was called. I believe they called a balk on the pitcher. So Nord will take second. The play is a dead ball, and Jenks will come back and do it again. So a little bit of a break there for the Nitros, as it was a nice one-hop snag by Bautista. Would have ended the inning, but a balk was called, so Nord gets second base, and Jenks gets another pitch. Olguin from the stretch turns, picks towards second. They had Nord picked off. The ball goes into center field, so Nord will take third base on the error by the pitcher. So Olguin, with a nice move, had Nord picked off. The only thing he could do was take off towards third, but unfortunately for the Pirates, the ball goes into center field. No, it's an error. And so now a runner down the line at third, a pass ball or wild pitch can bring in a run. Here's the pitch to Jenks, swinging, pops it foul, back of the plate. Catcher Rivera coming back toward the screen, and it's going to hit the overhang and go out of play. So the fence behind the plate goes up, and then it bends in toward the field. And so as the ball was coming down, it hit the top of the fence that's bent in toward the field, and it gives Jenks a reprieve. So he's had a couple reprieves. It's like a cat with nine lives up there. He's used two of them. One ball, one strike to count. Nord taking his lead away from first. Olguin from the stretch is ready. Deals on the breaking ball. Swung on, a tapper towards the third baseman, Mendez. He's charging. Up with it, fires to first. In time, and they got him. And that will end the inning. A close play at first, but they're able to get Jenks to retire the side, and the inning comes to a close. 5-3 on the putout. No runs, no hits. Two walks, an error, and a man left on. At the end of an inning and a half, 2-0 Nitros. We're back with the bottom of the second inning right after this.
Scandia Cleaning Service has been cleaning churches, private schools, and offices for over 30 years. And now you can take advantage of their experience, knowledge, and skills and have your facility cleaned by a company that will take a personal interest in both your regular and special cleaning needs. Call Scandia Cleaning Service at 818-388-5546 for a free estimate. Call 818-388-5546. That's Scandia Cleaning Service, where all work is done with care to your satisfaction.
Do your child a favor and open a checking and savings account for them at Los Angeles Federal Credit Union. Los Angeles Federal Credit Union helps young people make smart financial choices with free financial literacy classes and low-rate loan programs customized for first-time borrowers. Great customer service, financially secure, Los Angeles Federal Credit Union is the smart choice for you and your child's future. Visit them online at www.lafcu.org. Los Angeles Federal Credit Union, your financial source for life.
So back here at Paramount High School, as we get set for the bottom of the second inning, the Nitros lead it 2-0. And due up for the Pirates, you've got Poot, Padilla, and Burgos. 4, 5, and 6 in the lineup. The Nitros were able to get the Pirates to go down in order in the top of the first inning. Bautista popped up to the pitcher. Mendez fouled out to the third baseman, and Medina popped up to the first baseman. And so now Poot standing in. We're at number 14, hitting 167 on the season. And the first pitch swinging. There's a ground ball towards first. Nice hop for Trent. He'll take it to the bag. One pitch, one down. So Koverick out for his second inning of work. Faced four batters, retired all four. And that brings up Omar Padilla. We're in number 9. He's appeared in 2 games. He's 0 for 2. He does have a walk and a run scored. Right-handed hitter standing in. So Koverick cruising right now through 4 batters. Working from the stretch with nobody on, is ready and delivers. And the pitch, fastball taken high, ball 1. 1-0 the count. So, again, you've got this game here, and then tomorrow at noon versus Summit at Glendale High. But, again, it's supposed to rain, so who knows if we get that game in. The next pitch runs inside as Padilla able to get out of the way, turning away from it. Although that's the type of pitch that, if you're a coach, you're telling your player, stand in there, turn, and take it. Need base runners. 2-0 the count to Padilla. Here's the next offering from Koverick. Fastball on the outside part of the plate for a strike. And then Saturday, the Nitros go to Northview in Covina, 10 a.m. start time, and we'll have to see if we can get that game in due to weather conditions, field conditions, etc. Next pitch runs inside, 3-1 to count to Padilla. And then next week, we start the Pacific League play with Burrows on Tuesday and then next Friday. Koverick with a 3-1 offering, swinging. Padilla fouls it off, first base side, back out of play. And the count runs full, 3-2. It'll be interesting to see what happens in league, that's for sure. I don't think maybe Arcadia is the dominant team. Right now, Arcadia is undefeated. I think they're 7-0 on the season. There's the pitch, swung on and fouled back. So Padilla still alive, battling up there with a full count. Yeah, so Arcadia, 7-0. Pasadena's 8-4. Muir is 4-2-1. CB, 5-3. Burroughs, 6-6. Burbank, 2-3. Hoover, 1-9. And the Nitros, 2-4-1. That's how the Pacific League stands right now as far as teams and their record in non-league play. So Koverick with a 3-2 count, working from the stretch, is ready. And he delivers, and the breaking ball is thrown behind the batter. And the Pirates will have their first runner aboard. So the first walk off it up there by Thomas, and so Padilla is aboard with one out, runner at first. That brings up the center fielder, Joshua Burgos. Burgos, a junior, hitting .267. He has four hits and 15 at-bats, a double, an RBI, and three runs scored. Padilla taking his lead away from first, being held on by Trent. The pitch to the plate catches the outside corner for a strike. Nothing and one the count. Again, the Pirates hitting .219 on the season coming into this one. They have an on-base percentage of .345. It says they only have one stolen base, so I guess they're really not a threat to go. But now, as I say that, the guy goes hit and run. No, he doesn't. That's a bluff. As the batter swings and misses, comes up empty, and he's down in the count now. Nothing and two. So Padilla bluffing from first, and Burgos swinging on a pitch off the plate outside. Looked like it might have been a hit and run, but then the runner stopped running. Here's the 0-2 pitch. Strike three called as it catches the corner, and down goes Burgos. First strikeout of the game for Thomas. Two down, runner at first for Chris Rivera, the catcher. Rivera wearing number 22. He is a senior, hitting .333 on the year. He's 5 for 15 with five singles and three RBI. He's also walked once, been hit by a pitch a couple times, and struck out three. Looks like the Pirates have left a lot of men on. Looks like they've left 52 men on base in eight games. Pitch taken high, ball one. So they do get their runners on. They just can't cash them in. It looks like the story goes according to the stats. Paramount High School is where we are at. Bottom of the second inning, 2-0. Nitro's on top. They scored two runs on the first as the first two batters reached via the walk and came around to score. The pitch from Kovarik taken low. That runs the count to two balls to the catcher Rivera. Again, the Pirates with only one stolen base on the year, and Padilla bluffing there a moment ago. Bluffs again. The pitch outside. And the count runs 3-0. The pitcher, Gabriel Olguin, on deck. The Nitro shut down the Pirates in the first inning. 1-2-3. Actually got the first four hitters, then the walk, and then a strikeout. Showing bunt, 3-0. Takes ball four. And now you've got runners on at first and second. This is what we were kind of talking about as far as pitch efficiency and too many free passes. We've seen it time and time again from the opposition where they make the defense make the play. For example, yesterday, San Dimas, they were playing small ball. They'd get runners on at first and second, nobody out, they're bunting the ball. They made the Nitros defensively have to make plays, and a couple of times the Nitros couldn't. All you have to do is, you know, put the ball in play, so to speak. If you are a hitter, make the defense make the play. And if you're on defense, a pitcher, make the offense have to make the play. We've got a pinch runner at first. So somebody running over there for the catcher as he can go back in and get his gear on. And so the pitcher, Olguin, at the plate, takes a pitch in there. The left-handed batter down in the count now, nothing and one. So strike one the count to Olguin, a chance to help his cause with a runner at second base. RBI opportunity. The pitch swinging, fouls it off. Third base side and quickly down in the count. Nothing and two. So Thomas with an opportunity now, one pitch away to get out of it without giving up any more damage. We're in the second. 2-0 is the score. And just a reminder, if we go off the air quickly, it's because the rains came in. Kovarik checks the runner at second and delivers, and the pitch is outside. On deck, Edgar Sanchez. And it looks like six. Steve Garvey's number. So one ball, two strikes to count. Here's the next offering. Swinging, there's a fly ball towards center field. Cole giving chase. He's not going to get there. It lands in the gap. That's going to score a run. Here comes the second run, flying around third base as Rivera's base runner. Pinch runner is going to score. Two runs across on the double by Olguin, the pitcher helping his cause, and we're tied at two. So Padilla scores from second, and on the hit with two outs, I believe that was Medina running. No, maybe not. Yeah, maybe it was Medina. Anyways, two runs come across. Olguin, the pitcher, helping his cause with a double and two RBI, and that brings up the number nine hitter, Edgar Sanchez. So 2-2 tie here in the second inning. Got a delay in the action as the pitcher, Olguin, gets a sweatshirt from the dugout, and he'll go back to second base, and then the catcher, Wong, goes out to talk to his pitcher. So we've seen it time and time again. The free passes, the walks, and the hit batters come back to haunt you. And Thomas gives up a couple free passes, and Olguin makes him pay. Just like in the top of the first inning, Olguin came up with a couple of free passes to the Nitros, walking Edom and Wong, and then the Nitros made him pay. Pitch to Sanchez, over for a strike. Nothing in one to count. So 2-2 tie here in the second inning. Here's the next pitch. Just off the mark. One ball, one strike to count. Pitch missing a bit outside. So 2-2 tie here in the bottom of the second. Gobert now trying to get out of it. The go-ahead run standing on at second base for the Pirates. The next pitch swung on, fouled off. Over toward the first base dugout, occupied by the home team. And now Sanchez down in the count, a ball and two strikes. Sanchez, the sixth batter to come to the plate for the Pirates here this inning. Apparently, yeah, I'm going to refrain. Too many Pirate puns to put in here, make it too simple. Pitch is in the dirt. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. 2-2 tie in the second. As Vin Scully used to say, the deuces are wild. Thomas, one pitch away from getting out of it, is ready and delivers, and the pitch swinging, a one-hopper back to the pitcher. Kovarik with it. Underhand toss over to first, and the inning comes to a close. 1-3 on the putout, but the damage is done. For the Pirates, they do pick up two runs. They do that on one hit. No Nitro errors, and a man left on. At the end of two complete, it's a 2-2 tie. We're back to Paramount with inning number three. Right after this.
Fair Oaks Orthodontics in South Pasadena provides family-friendly care for the entire family. Their team is second to none when it comes to a caring and generous staff. Dr. Craig Chung and Dr. Leslie Jung believe that everybody deserves to have a beautiful smile. They are also Invisalign certified, meaning clear braces. Located at 1318 Fair Oaks Avenue, Suite A in South Pasadena, call them at 626-795-5978. Check them out on the web at cjsmiles.com. That's Fair Oaks Orthodontics in South Pasadena.
So we are back here at Paramount High School as we head to the third inning. It's a whole new ballgame, 2-2 tie between the Pirates and the Nitros. And due up for the Nitros here in the third inning, you've got Kovarik, Aldretti, and Rangel, 4, 5, and 6 in the lineup. Olguin out for his third inning of work. He's given up two runs on a hit. He's walked five, struck out one. And the lone hit, Aldretti, with a single driving in a run in that first inning. Davin walked in that first inning and then stole two bases and then scored on the throwing error by the catcher. And then Wong came in on the RBI single by Aldretti for their two runs. So Kovarik, Aldretti, and Rangel. So Kovarik now with an opportunity to jump right back into it and give himself a chance to get some of those runs back. He went 0-for-2 against San Dimas with two strikeouts yesterday. Had a hit, a double against Canyon. A single against Arleta and a single against Desert Christian. In that 19-2 victory. So Olguin is ready and the third inning underway as Kovarik takes a pitch high and away, ball one. So Kovarik reached on the error and then Nord ran for him and got to third and was left there. The Nitros left the bases loaded in that first inning. They've left four men on base in the first two innings as the next pitch off the mark to Koverik, and he's ahead in the count now 2-0. Olguin ready and delivers ball three. 3-0 the count. So five walks for Olguin. Nitro's cashing in for two runs. Here's the 3-0 offering. High ball four, and Koverik draws the walk. So we should get a pinch runner. Sixth walk offered up by Olguin, and Nord will make his way towards first base, the sophomore. The catcher, Rivera, heading out to the mound to talk to his pitcher, and he was motioning to the dugout to his coach, and now it looks like we might have perhaps an injury to Olguin. Maybe he pulled a muscle. Because now the umpire motioning for the Paramount coach to head to the mound. And it looks like Olguin trying to stretch out his leg or something. So we might have an issue here for Olguin. It was kind of an interesting story coming here. Because the rain has been an issue the last couple of weeks for baseball with field conditions and so forth. Hadn't rained here at Paramount, but apparently a sprinkler broke, kind of flooding the field in certain spots, and so they had to work on the field to get it in game shape from the flooded sprinkler. Field looks like it's in good condition, but again, I'm not the one out there playing on it. Now it looks like Olguin's down on the ground back behind the mound and looking to stretch it out. Usually you get your cramps on warm days, don't you? Yeah. Not having enough water? Yeah, on a cold day, usually it's a pulled muscle or something because your muscles are tight and you go to make a move, and because your muscles are cold and tight, it pulls something. But apparently the pitcher suffering from some sort of muscle ailment.
If the cramp goes away, you'll be fine. You know?
Yeah, well, that's the difference between the two. You know, if you got some cramping going on, that'll go away, usually with some hydration. But if you pull the muscle or something, that's not going to go away anytime soon, unless you just kind of tweaked it and need a moment to collect yourself. See, I kind of paid attention in health class. So we're in the third inning. Koverik, the leadoff hitter, reached via the walk, and now Ian Nord running for him. And that will bring to the plate Ethan Aldretti. He singled, driving in a run, stole a base, and was stranded at second in that first inning. Again, the Nitros leaving four men on base so far. So Aldretti with the second RBI of the season in his last at-bat. His first RBI came against Desert Christian. Even I got an RBI in that 19-2 win. Showing bunt, takes a pitch low. Ball one. Aldretti had a four-game hit streak to start the season. He's been hitless in the last two games. And we are in that third inning now, like I mentioned. Both teams, the Nitros and the opposition, throw to first, not in time. The ball scoots away from the first baseman, Poot, but not far enough for Nord to advance. So both teams in the third inning of Nitro games this year have combined for 31 runs. The opposition have scored 17 and the Nitros 14. So we could be in for a wild ride here in the third. Showing bunt, the pitch taken high, ball two. Nitros in the last two games have only been able to muster up four hits, a run and four hits, while giving up 27 runs on 23 hits. Nitros have also committed 10 errors in the last two games. And prior to that, in their prior five, as the bunt taken for a strike. In their first five games, they committed eight errors. In the last two, they've committed 10. So they really want to put something good here and bury the memories of Canyon and San Dimas. Swinging as a fly ball towards left center field. The center fielder Burgos is there in the gap to make the catch. And we've got one down. So Aldretti is retired. And that brings up Nate Rangel, who walked his first time up. So Rangel had two plate appearances, two at-bats against Arleta, and then he got a single in his lone at-bat against Southgate. So he's 1-for-3 on the season. Right-handed hitter standing in, swinging at the first pitch as a ground ball to third, taken there by Mendez. Over to second for one, down to first, in time, double play. It's a pitcher's best friend, and for the second consecutive game, the Nitros hit into a double play, and that will end the top of the third inning. 5-4-3 on the putout. No runs, no hits, no errors, a walk, and nobody left on. At the end of 2.5, we're tied at 2. We're back with the bottom of the third inning right after this.
Do you want to be a part of a television studio audience? Audiences Unlimited has been helping people see their favorite sitcoms live since 1982. Hit shows such as Growing Pains, Home Improvement, Friends, Will and Grace, and 2.5 Men. Contact audiencesunlimited.com to get your chance to visit a working studio lot, be on the set of popular television shows, and see your favorite stars in person. They offer free tickets on their website. They also offer fundraising opportunities for groups of 10 or more. Visit www.audiencesunlimited.com and get your free TV tickets today. This is a unique Hollywood experience not to be missed.
Ladies, are you looking to rearrange your room? Don't leave it in the hands of your man. Let Interiors by Jada provide you with a design concept that will make your room feel comfortable and be beautifully functional. Interiors by Jada is dedicated to giving you a perfectly designed space any place in your home. Whether it be the living room, kitchen, bedroom, or bath, their focus is to make each space a place of beauty while creating functionality and use. Put your room in the hands of the professionals. Contact Interiors by Jada at 818-481-8992 or check them out on the web at www.interiorsbyjada.com.
So back here at Paramount High School as we get set for the bottom of the third inning. And due up for the Pirates, the top of the lineup, Bautista, Mendez, and Medina, all a part of that 1-2-3 bottom of the first inning. You take a look at this Paramount program. They're 1-7 on the season. They went 12-13-1 last year, but in 2016, 20-game winner, 21-12, finishing 7-3 in their league, which was second to Gar, who has won the conference championship the last 3 years. You look back in their history, and you go back to the year 2011 when Paramount went 22-7 overall, 13-2, and they won the league championship, losing the first round of the playoffs to Culver City by a score of 9-5. Govaric throws the pitch to the backstop, ball one. So Bautista, 0-1, popped up to the pitcher his first time up. And then you look back to 2009, in which Paramount went 12-3, and they tied with Downey for the league championship. But their biggest year was probably 2008. Next pitch, inside, ball two. In 2008, the Pirates went 25-5, and they had a 25-game win streak. They lost their first five games, won 25 in a row, including going 15-0 in league for the championship, lost in the third round of the playoffs to Elsinore 4-0. Showing bunt, takes the pitch high, ball three, 3-0. And then the year before that, in 07, they went 22-5. So they went 47-10-1 in 2 years, including a 29-1 league mark and a couple of championships for the league and a couple of playoff appearances in 07-08. Kind of dipped since then. Pitch is outside, ball four. So the third walk offered up by Kovarik. Leadoff hitter is aboard. And that brings up Robert Mendez. He fouled out to Rangel at third his first time up. Yesterday, in the game against San Dimas, the Nitros defensively shut down the Saints in order in the first inning. And then ever since then, the rest of the game, the leadoff hitter got aboard in every inning. And the leadoff hitter scored in every inning. Throw to first, not in time. Bautista back to the bag. Overall, since the 2005 season, Paramount 223 wins, 160 losses, and two ties. Nitros have had a couple ties last year to Foothill, or to Flint Ridge Prep, and this year to Foothill Tech. Showing bunt, Mendez takes a pitch in there for a strike. Mendez wearing 13, again hitting 091 coming into the contest. He's 0-for-1 on the day. His lone hit coming against CV on Saturday, St. Paddy's Day. In there with a one-strike count. Nitros would like to turn two here. There goes the runner from first. The pitch swung on and missed. The throw down to second. Not in time. And the Pirates with their second stolen base of the season, but the hit and run was on as Mendez swinging and missing. And now he's down in the count. So a stolen base for Bautista. Mendez with one hit on the season, looking for his first RBI, can pick it up and give the Pirates a lead with a single. One ball, one strike, the count. Here's the next pitch from Kovarik. Curveball swung on, pop foul back of first. Trent giving a chase, and that's going to be a foul ball. Mendez down in the count now, a ball and two strikes. So no balls, two strikes, the count. Scoreboard was a bit off there. So Mendez at the plate. Medina on deck. You've got Bautista taking his lead away from second. Here's the pitch from Kovarik. Swinging, there's a flare that hoards second base. Caught by Damon. Underhand toss to second, but not in time as Bautista's back to the bag. And we've got one down. So Mendez is retired. And that brings up Raimundo Medina. Medina, again, hitting .353 coming into the contest with an on-base percentage of .450. He's 0-for-1, popped up to Trent at first in the first inning to end the bottom of the first. On deck, Michael Poot. Fastball taken high, ball one to Medina. Medina had a hit against CV on Saturday, the 17th. Had a couple of two-hit ball games, one against Long Beach Poly and the other against Sunny Hills, and then he got a hit against La Habra in the season opener. Pirates 1-7 on the season. They beat Pasadena yesterday 3-2 as the next pitch is high, ball two. 2-0. Medina?
Number two?
Yeah. Yeah, Medina. Number two, yeah. So 2-0 the count to Medina. And the next pitch from Kovarik, low, ball three. Good stop by Wong behind the plate to keep the runner at second. Bautista opened up the inning with the walk. He represents the go-ahead run here in the third inning. Three balls, no strikes the count. We'll see if Medina is taking a pitch here, 3-0. Most of the time you are, but with the number three hitter at the plate, you just never know. And a guy hitting .353 on the season, you might give him the green light, especially when you're 1-7, and he does have the green light, and he swings and fouls it back. Three balls and one strike to count. Son Edom with you from Paramount High School, alongside Stuart Edom, bringing you Nitro's baseball here on EdomRocksRadio.com, also Facebook living the game at Facebook.com/EdomRocksRadio.com. So two balls and one strike to count. Here's the pitch. The runner going to third. The pitch taken for ball four. The throw down to third. Not in time. And a stolen base for Bautista. And then Medina draws the walk. So the fourth walk offered up by Kovarik puts runners at the corners. Kevin, Coach Chan heading to the mound to talk to his pitcher. And with one out, runners at the corners for Michael Poot, the cleanup hitter. Poot 0-for-1 in the game. He hit a ground ball to first base to open the bottom of the second inning. We're at number 14. He's a sophomore. And so we've got Conference on the mound. Kovarik in his third inning of work has a strikeout. He's given up four walks, one hit, and two runs. The lone hit was the pitcher Olguin, who doubled into the left center field gap, driving home Padilla and Rivera. And so now Coach Chan making his way back to the dugout. And you've got the left-handed hitting Poot now climbing into the batter's box at the plate. Medina taking his lead away from first, showing bunt. The squeeze is on, and nobody covering third as Rangel was charging on the play. And so Bautista able to get back to the bag. Medina takes second base as the pitch is taken for ball one. So Poot now with two RBIs sitting for him. Bautista at third and Medina at second. So now the infield drawn in. With one out and runners at second and third. Outfield playing straight away. We've got a breeze blowing out. So Poot standing in, a 167 hitter coming into the contest with three hits, looking for his first RBI of the season. Takes a pitch outside, a little bit high, ball two. 2-0 the count to Poot, the cleanup hitter for the Pirates. You're in the bottom of the third inning. 2-2 score. Nitro's got their two in the top of the first. Pirates got theirs in the bottom of the second. Looking for more here. Next pitch swinging, sends a fly ball back of second base. And Jenks looking for it, can't find it. The runner from third is going to score in Bautista.
Is that a single?
Yeah. Staying at second base is Medina, and Poot will get a gift with a base hit and an RBI. It looked like that might have just gotten lost in the clouds. As the infield was drawn in, the infield going back towards center field, not able to pick it up unless the infield fly rule was called. No, you can't have an infield fly rule because you got runners at second and third. So the run scores, making the 3-2 Pirates. Medina stays at second, Poot at first with the RBI single. And now the infield will, middle infielders will play back, double play depth. So the Pirates getting a gift there. With Jenks, who's playing on the infield grass, having to go back to the outfield grass to try to make the over-the-shoulder catch. And with the color of the skies overhead, couldn't quite pick up the ball. And was able to fall to the ground. Pitch over for a strike. So nothing and one the count now to Padilla. He walked and scored in the second inning. The next pitch is in the dirt, gets away from the catcher. Now you've got a runner going to third to throw to third to Rangel. They've got a runner hung up between second and third. There's a toss to Jenks. Jenks running the runner towards third, the throw to Kavarik. And Kavarik makes the tag, and there's the out by the base umpire. 2-5-6-1. So 2-5-6-1 on the putout. Going to second base is Poot. And we've got two away. Runner at second, a run across, 3-2 Pirates, and Padilla at the plate with a nothing and one, or a strike one count. Fastball taken high. Well, yeah. Yep. Yep, two balls on a strike. Yep. Runner with his lead away from second is Poot. The pitch to the plate catches the corner. Strike two. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. 3-2 Pirates here in the bottom of the third inning. Let's see if Kovarik can end it here with a pitch. Working from the stretch, checks the runner at second. Poot with a big lead, and there's ball four, ball three delivered to the plate. So the count runs full now, three balls and two strikes. On deck, Joshua Burgos. So the leadoff walk came around to score, and then Medina kind of got caught in no man's land on a wild pitch on a nice stop by the catcher, Wong, and he was thrown out. And there's ball four. That is the fifth walk offered up by Kovarik. We've got two down, runners at first and second for Joshua Burgos. He struck out, caught looking his first time up. He's 0 for 1. We're in number 3. A 267 hitter on the season. 389 on base percentage, 4 hits, and an RBI looking for more. Takes a pitch inside, ball 1. So we talked about the third inning being the highest scored inning combined for both teams, the opposition and the Nitros. Nitros weren't able to cash anything in, but the Pirates getting one. Nice stop by Wong. There goes the runner to third. The throw to Rangel. The tag. Got him. And they got him. So nice play by Wong and a good throw down to third. And Rangel making the catch, applying the tag, holding on to the ball as he gets knocked over. And Poot is retired. That'll go 2-5 on the putout. And the Pirates running themselves out of an inning, getting two men thrown out at third base. But they do get the lead as they pick up a run. They do that on one hit. No Nitro errors, and they do leave a man on. At the end of 3, the Pirates lead it by a score of 3-2, and we're back after this.
Tequila's Restaurant in Burbank offers the best authentic Mexican food at great prices, including lunch Monday through Thursday for only $5.99 and dinner buffets for only $7.99. Enjoy a great all-you-can-eat brunch on both Saturdays and Sundays. Go to their website, www.tequilasrestaurant.com, for the latest specials and download coupons for even greater savings. Tequila's Restaurant is located at 4310 West Magnolia Boulevard in Burbank on the corner of Pass Avenue. Call them 818-845-7217. Flowers Talk in Burbank is a nice family-run flower shop with the best prices in town. At Flowers Talk, you will find a wide selection of floral arrangements, or you can select the flowers of your choice in their do-it-yourself section. Stop by Flowers Talk in Burbank and let their expert staff help you create the best flower arrangement. If they don't have it, they will get it for you. Mention Burbank or Burroughs High School and receive 10% off your entire order. Flowers Talk, located at 2460 West Victory Boulevard in Burbank, or on the web at www.flowerstalkburbank.com.
So we head to the fourth inning with the Pirates on top by a score of 3-2. Nitros with 2 in the first, the Pirates with 2 in the second and 1 in the third, and Trent leading things off for the Nitros, takes a pitch over for a strike. Trent 0 for 1 on the game, struck out, caught looking his first time up. The next pitch, a curveball missing inside. The count moves to a ball and a strike. So Trent yesterday went 0 for 1 with a strikeout against San Dimas. Here's the next pitch from Olguin. Catches the corner, strike 2. He had 2 hits against Desert Christian and a hit against Southgate for his 3 hits. Been in a little bit of a slump as of late. Here's a good time to get out of that slump. Swinging, there's a fly ball towards left center field. That's going to drop in for a base hit. And on cue, Trent gets a base hit, and maybe that's the start of him getting out of his slump. So that is the second hit for the Nitros. They've had 6 walks and 2 hits. So the leadoff hitter is aboard for the third consecutive inning. They scored in the first, and the 5-4-3 double play extinguished Kevork / Nord in the third, and now you've got Mike Titchener with a runner at first. He popped up to the second baseman his first time up. Takes a pitch in there for a strike. Nothing and 1 the count. Titchener yesterday against San Dimas went 1-for-2. Got the lone hit. Also had a strikeout. Couple of hits against Desert Christian in that 19-2 victory. And a hit against Arleta. Throw to first. Not in time. Trent diving back to the bag. He drove in 2 against Desert Christian, also scored a couple runs. Swinging, sends a flare towards the first base side, but it goes foul beyond the reach of anybody. Boot, the closest guy there, couldn't get there. And so that makes the count nothing and 2 to Titchener. On deck, Adrian Cole. 3-2, Pirates lead it here in the fourth inning. Olguin working from the stretch is ready and deals, and the pitch is swung on and fouled back. So Titchener up there battling with 2 strikes. Got a runner at first in Trent Lucerarian. Got everybody bundled up. Apparently there's supposed to be a nor'easter hitting the northeast here in the next week or so. Got some storms coming in ourselves, but not as bad as the snow and stuff that's supposed to be predicted for the East Coast. Throw to first, not in time. Trent back to the bag. Trent taking his lead, being held on by Poot. Here's the pitch to the plate. Swinging, there's a line drive, base hit into center field. Trent racing to second, and he's able to get there in time just before the throw from Burgos. And you've got runners on at first and second with nobody out for the Nitros here in the fourth inning. Back-to-back hits, that's the third hit of the game. And so for Titchener, he's got back-to-back contests, a little two-game hit streak. So that brings up Adrian Cole. We have him walking his first time. Yeah, walk. Sometimes I can't read my own writing. So again, Cole looking for his first hit of the season. Wearing number 15. He's 0 for 5 with a walk. Showing bunt. Actually, he's 0 for 5. They got the pickoff move to second, but Trent back to the bag. So Cole coming into the game 0 for 5 with a walk, picks up his second walk of the season in his first at-bat. So the Pirates putting the play on at second, trying to backpick Trent. Shortstop was breaking towards third. The second baseman came in to cover. Olguin spun and threw to second. Showing bunt, the pitch taken high. Corners come charging as Cole turns to bunt. So ball one the count. Now we got to have a conference on the mound. Apparently looking to see if they can get Trent sleeping over there at second base. On deck, Dave and Edom. So Cole, the number 9 hitter in the lineup, looking to perhaps move the runners over and set the table for the top of the lineup. 1-0 the count. Olguin from the stretch. Cole showing bunt. The pitch taken low. Ball two. Throw down the first. Not in time. Getting back to the bag was Titchener. The other thing, too, that I don't think Trent has the speed. But the third baseman is crashing, leaving the base wide open. So if you were quicker than the faster than the shortstop, you can just beat him to the bag. Is the 2-0 showing bunt, the pitch taken high, ball three. 3-0 the count. This is always kind of interesting because you've got a batter at the plate that's going to give you an out. And the pitcher has yet to throw a strike. Three balls, no strikes the count. We're in the fourth inning. 3-2 is the score. Pirates on top. Showing bunt again. And the pitch is ball four and the bases are loaded. So you've got Trent to third. Titchener to second. You've got Cole to first, and that brings up the top of the lineup. And the skipper for the Pirates heading out to the mound to talk to his pitcher. And could that be it for Olguin? He's gone three innings. He's walked seven, struck out one. He's allowed three hits and two runs, both of them earned. And that is indeed going to be it for Olguin. So Olguin will be done. Can't get an out here in the third inning. And we'll have a new pitcher. And it looks like the new pitcher is number 11. I'll figure out who that is here in a moment. Looks like George Reyes, a senior pitcher, coming in to pitch now. So Olguin goes three innings, striking out one, walking seven. So far, allowing two runs on three hits, but everybody on base belongs to him. And that will bring up Reyes, will be the new pitcher. Reyes, a senior. He's 0 for 2 on the season. He's appeared in two games. He has an ERA of 10.08. He's pitched in 8 1/3 innings. He's allowed 12 runs, all earned on 18 hits. striking out 2, walking 3. He's faced 44 batters. And again, he is 0-2 on the season with an ERA of 10.08 as he is a senior making his third appearance on the mound for the Pirates. Looks like him and Bautista, two of the main pitchers on the staff for the Pirates. Looks like a sophomore pitcher, Larga Zapata, has gone 11 innings as their number one. But it doesn't have him as a number, and we don't see him on the lineup. So you've got now Reyes pitching, a right-handed pitcher. And the first batter he will face is the leadoff hitter, David Edom. Edom 0-for-1. He walked, stole a couple bases, and scored back in the first, and then flew out to center field in the second. Still kind of an interesting at-bat because Cole before him walked on 4 straight pitches, and then Wong behind him walked. But now he has a chance to drive in some runs and give the Nitros the lead, or at least tie it up. He had 3 RBI against Desert Christian. He had an RBI against Monroe, the game-winning walk-off hit in the bottom of the 8th inning, and an RBI against Southgate. So he has 5 RBI on the season, a right-handed batter standing in, and the first pitch swung on and missed, strike 1. Nothing and 1 the count. You've got the infield drawn in. You do have a vast outfield, so all you need to do is put the ball in play somewhere, and you've got Titchener with some speed at second, and you're scoring 2 runs. Reyes working from the windup with the bases loaded and the breaking ball taken high. 1-1 the count. Got to be patient up there. It's like the buffet. You get there with your eyes really big thinking all this food. Hitter, eyes are pretty big with all these runners on. Swinging, there's a drive towards left field. That's going to be over the left fielder's head. That's going to go to the wall. That could clear the bases. Trent comes in to score. Titchener rounding third. He's going to come in to score. Adrian Cole hot on his heels. Here comes the throw to the plate. Not in time. David on his way to third. He's in there under the sliding tag. And just like that, you've got 3 runs across, 5-3. Nitros with the lead on a double by David. He takes third on the throw home. He has 3 RBI. And just like that, the senior leadoff hitter comes up big, a big clutch hit. And we talked about getting out of these slumps. Trent started it with a base hit, perhaps breaking his slump, and David comes back with a double to left field, driving home 3, and the Nitros lead it 5-3. And that will close the books on the pitcher, Ray Olguin, as he scores or gives up those 3 runs. Yep. The pitch to Wong taken low and away, ball 1. 1-0 count to Nolan Wong. So David with the double, 3 RBI. Next pitch to Wong is taken low. And you can close the book on Olguin, giving up 6 runs. All of them earned. Next pitch to Wong, swinging, pulls it foul down the first baseline, and that's just foul on the foul ball side of the bag. What's that? Yeah, what did I say, 6? Yeah, 5. I think I've got their hits confused with their runs. Again, I've got, I can't read my own writing. So 5-3 is the score now, and a bases clearing double by David, taking third on the throw to the plate. 1-2 the count to Nolan Wong with an RBI opportunity himself. The pitch taken high. So David now on the season with 8 RBI. And so for Wong, a chance to pick up his 4th RBI. Infield drawn in, looking to make the play at the plate. The pitch is ball 3, low and away to Nolan. The count full now, 3-2. And again, Nolan up there looking for a pitch to drive. You've got Darian Shanks on deck. There's the payoff pitch from Reyes. Swing, and there's a line drive past the first baseman, Poot, into right field. That will score Davin from third, and Nolan Wong picks up his fourth RBI of the season. Another run across for the Nitros here in the fourth inning, and Glendale leads it by a score of 6-3. And so that brings up Darian Jenks. He's 0-2, fouled out to the catcher, and then grounded out to third to end the second inning. With a runner at first, a chance to keep the inning alive. He had a five-game hit streak to start the season, including a two-hitter against Desert Christian. Swings, check swings, and fouls are back. And then ran into Canyon and San Dimas. He went 0-1 with a walk against San Dimas. So a chance for him now to kind of break out of this two-game slump. Strike one, the count. Throw to first, not in time. Nord running for Wong back to the bag. Is that only three hits for Olguin? I think Olguin only gave up three hits, but seven walks. There's a fly ball towards center field, drifting back on the plays. The center fielder, Burgos. He's under it to make the catch, and we've got one down. And that brings up Thomas Kovarik, the pitcher, with a runner at first and one away. Four runs across in the inning for the Nitros. They're on top now in the top of the fourth inning by a score of 6-3. No, they got, because Davin came in on that ground ball, or that base hit by Wong. Yeah. And the first pitch to Thomas, over for a strike. Nothing and one to count. So Nord, who's been running for Thomas on the previous two times that Thomas has been up. Swinging, there's a towering fly ball towards left field. Fair territory. The left fielder Padilla comes down and makes the catch, and we've got two away. And that answers that question, because I was going to say, who's going to run? Because Nord's already on base. So two outs, runner at first, and that brings up Ethan Aldretti. Aldretti with a base hit, an RBI, and a stolen base back in the first inning. And a fly out to center field last inning, so he's 1-2. He's the eighth man to come to the plate in this inning for the Nitros. Here's the pitch. Nope, balk. And that will send Nord to second base. That is the second balk of the game for the Pirates pitching staff. Now an RBI opportunity for Aldretti. He already has one in the game. That's his second of the season. He had one against Desert Christian, so a chance to have a multi-RBI game as the Paramount skipper heading to the mound to talk to the umpire about the balk call, about whether the pitcher's coming set or not. And they're going to have a long conversation about it, because it doesn't look like this is going to end anytime soon. So 6-3, the Nitros with two runs in the first, four here in the fourth. The Pirates with two in the second and one in the third. Davin and Wong scoring in the first, and then Trent, Titchener, and Cole coming in on the double by Davin, and then Davin scoring on the base hit by Wong. And so that's where we stand right now, 6-3 here in the top of the fourth inning. Nitro's coming off that 10-0 loss to San Dimas yesterday. They are supposed to play Summit tomorrow at noon Pacific time. Again, the rain going to depend on whether or not we play that game due to the rain. And then the next game scheduled for the Nitros will be on Saturday, 10 a.m. Pacific time, against Northview out of Covina. If, again, rain and field conditions allow it. So it doesn't look like the Pirates coaching staff is happy with the base umpire right now after that call. Nord taking his lead away from second. Reyes working from the stretch. Is ready and deals, and the pitch to Aldretti's a fastball taken high, ball one. On deck is Nate Rangel, the ninth hitter, if he comes to the plate this inning for the Nitros. Reyes again working from the stretch, sets at the belt, checks the runner at second, into his motion, and delivers a pitch over for a strike. 1-1 the count. Looks like the breeze has let up a little bit as the flag, Old Glory, draped on the foul pole, on the flag pole. Next pitch taken inside for ball two. And again, we're supposed to have rain later tonight. And there was some question as to when it was going to come in. But with the rain or with the wind dying down, that might buy us some time to get through this entire game. Here's the 2-1 pitch in there for strike two. Because reports were as early as 8 o'clock, which is in 20 minutes Pacific time. Let's push it back to like, you know, 9, 9:30. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. There goes Nord to third. The pitch taken high for ball three. The throw down to third, not in time, and Nord with a stolen base. So full count now to Aldretti. Three balls, two strikes, two outs. Here in the top of the fourth inning, 6-3, Nitros. Reyes in relief. The pitch, low, ball four, and Aldretti is aboard. The eighth walk offered up by the Pirates pitching staff, and that brings Nate Rangel, the ninth hitter, to come to the plate this inning for the Nitros. You've got Nord down the line at third. We've got Aldretti at first being held on by Poot. So runners at the corners with two outs. Rangel on the night. He walked in the first and hit into the 5-4-3 double play to end the third inning his last time up. A junior playing third base for the Nitros here tonight. Here's the first offering of this at-bat. Swung on and missed. Strike one the count. On deck, Trent Lucerarian, who led off the inning with the base hit right on cue. To get this thing going. Four runs across in the inning. 6-3 is the score. Nitros with the lead. I guess the Nitros held off to the fourth inning to start scoring some runs for their big inning this game. Step off the third, throw to first, not in time. Aldretti back to the bag. Wasn't even really that far away from first base. Got back in standing up in plenty of time. So strike one the count to Rangel. Reyes from the belt is ready and delivers, and the fastball swinging. There's a fly ball towards left center field. The left fielder coming over, and Padilla is there to make the catch, and that will end the inning. For the Nitros, though, they send nine men to the plate. They do pick up four runs. They do that on four hits. No Pirate errors, and two men left on. They've gotten six runs, have the Nitros, in the ballgame through four innings. But they've also left six men on. We head to the bottom of the fourth, 6-3. Nitros with the lead. We're back after this.
Jody Maroney's Sausage Kingdom in Glendale offers their world-famous gourmet of sausage sandwiches grilled and served on their fresh-baked onion roll. Choose from a variety of delicious sandwiches off their menu, including the hot Italian, bratwurst, Polish, and chicken apple, or perhaps one of Jody Maroney's hot dogs, such as the giant Kobe beef, the Coney Island, or their Chicago style. Jody Maroney's located in the Americana on Brand Boulevard. You can also check them out on the web at jodymaroney.com. That's Jody Maroney's Sausage Kingdom, home of the hot dog.
Rocket Fizz offers a wide variety of specialty, retro, and imported sodas, candy, and novelty gifts. Zots, Pop Rocks, Bazooka Bubblegum, and a whole lot more. Make a special soda gift basket for your favorite Nitro. Beat those back-to-school blues with your favorite candy. Rocket Fizz, located at 138 North Brand Boulevard, is independently owned and operated. Check them out on the web at www.facebook.com/Glendale Rocket Fizz. Rocket Fizz, come be a kid in our store.
Taste the thrill of the day. And feel the Pepsi way.
So here we go as we head to the bottom of the fourth inning. Kovarik out for his fourth inning of work, and the first pitch to Burgos, the center fielder, is swung on and fouled off, strike one. So Burgos 0 for 1. He struck out his first time up. I'm going to replay. Not now. That's artificial intelligence taking over. So nothing and one the count to Burgos. Kovarik is ready. The right-handed pitcher delivers. A breaking ball catches the inside corner for strike two. And Burgos down in the count, nothing and two. Again, a 267 hitter coming into this game with four hits on the season. He's only struck out twice in eight games, on the verge of striking out for a second time here. The 0-2 pitch. Breaking ball just off the mark inside. One ball, two strikes to count. He struck out against Sunny Hills and against CV. This is the third consecutive game that Paramount has played against Pacific League teams. Pitch, strike three call with a fastball in the outside corner, and down goes Burgos. For the second time, he's caught looking. The second strikeout of the game for Kovarik. We've got one down, and that brings up the catcher, Chris Rivera. He walked and scored back in that second inning. The Pirates, they played Crescenta Valley and lost 5-2 on St. Patrick's Day. And then yesterday played against Pasadena and won 3-2, and now they're trailing here 6-3 in this one to the Nitros. The catcher, Rivera, standing in, right-handed batter, takes a pitch high, ball one. 1-0 the count. Wearing number 22. He was a 333 hitter coming into the contest with an on-base percentage of 444. Five hits and three RBI. Kovarik's next pitch swinging. There's a flare towards second base. Davin out on the grass is there to drop the ball. Yeah, he did. Oh, did the ball just land in? No, the guy's on first. I don't know. No, umpire ran across my view. I think he dropped the ball. Yep. Yep. Second consecutive game in which he's committed an error. I think he only had two errors all last year at second base. Couldn't really see exactly what happened as the umpire crossed my field of view. But, yeah, the ball ended up on the ground, and a runner's at first. Yep. So that brings up Angel Raider Peralta, number 24, batting in place of Olguin, who was the starting pitcher and who had a double, driving home two in his lone at-bat. At the time, tying the game up 2-2. Yes, Valerie, he needs a tutorial in fielding. Need to start giving him some tutoring lessons in fielding. Not good. So runner at first, Raider, as they call him, Peralta at the plate, swinging, sends a towering fly ball back behind the plate over our heads. It's always the rebound that gets you. It's never the fly ball that gets you. It's the rebound. It hits something and pinballs around, and then you get drilled. Yeah, Angel Raider Peralta, a 353 hitter on the season, 421 on-base percentage, has six hits and two RBI. He scored two runs, one out, runner at first. And Peralta at the plate, throw to first, not in time, just back to the bag. Yep, Rivera, or whoever's base running for Rivera. Is that number 22 down there? No. That's not Rivera. It's got to be a pinch runner. Here's the 1-1 pitch. There goes the runner. The pitch is low, and Wong drops the ball, and so it'll be a stolen base for the base runner. So 6-3 here in the bottom of the fourth inning. You got one out. Runner at second now. The base runner running for Rivera, who reached on the error by Davin. A routine flare towards second base. Just dropped the ball. Peralta now with an RBI opportunity. And on the pitch, you've got the runner taking third. And the count moves to 3-1. So 3-1, 1-1. Koberek working from the stretch. Got the base runner down the line at third. Peralta at the plate. The pitch swung on, fouled back. Count runs full now, 3-2. Koberek out for his fourth inning of work. Again, 2 strikeouts, 5 walks. He's given up. So 2 runs on 3 hits. Was it 2 runs on 2 hits? Here's the 3-2 pitch. Swinging, that is pulled foul. Yep, 2 runs on 2 hits. No, that's right. 3 runs on 2 hits. Now, stat book's a mess. Need stat book tutoring. So 3-2 the count. Here's the pitch. Swinging, that's pulled foul down the left field line. Yeah, again, it's interesting that he didn't start because he's a 353 hitter. Yep. He had a hit against CV, had a hit against Murrieta Valley, 2 hits against Long Beach Poly, and 2 hits against Yucaipa. So in the 6 games that he played, only 2 games in which he did not get a hit. That was La Habra and Sunny Hills. 3-2 the count. See if Koberek, maybe off-speed pitch, gets him out in front. 3-2 the count. The pitch, swinging, popped up. It was a breaking ball back of the plate, and Wong will come over to take a look, and that's on the dugout roof. So we'll do it again. A big battle brewing here between the pinch hitter, or the guy that takes over for Olguin, Peralta, and the pitcher, Koberek. So it'd be interesting to see if they have a pitching change now because they brought in Reyes to pitch for Olguin, and now Peralta is batting. So there's a double switch somewhere that they didn't tell us about. 3-2 the count. Here's the pitch from Thomas. High ball 4, and Peralta draws the walk. 6th walk offered up by Thomas. And that will bring up Ethan Sanchez, 0-1, hit a comebacker to Thomas, his first time up in the second inning. And so now the coach for the Pirates wanting to get a pinch runner, and now they say never mind, and Peralta will go back to first base to run. So it looked like they tried to get Damian Beltran to run, the sophomore, but changed their mind. And so Raider, as they call him, will stay on at first base. So we've got runners at the corners now. You've got the runner for Rivera down the line at third. You've got Peralta at first. You've got one away in the inning. And Sanchez at the plate, the second baseman. Showing bunt, lays the bunt down, back to the pitcher Koberek. Underhand toss to first. Now he comes to the plate. The run scores. And so I don't know what that play was, but the bunt was laid down. Koberek with an underhand toss to Trent, who was charging on the play. And then the runner from third comes home to score on the throw to first. And the run comes across. It's an unearned run, the 4th run of the ball game. And I don't know. I guess that goes as a fielder's choice. No, it goes as a fielder's choice. So 1 out, run across, makes it 6-4. Runners at first and second for the top of the lineup, Adrian Bautista. And he takes a pitch over for a strike. Nothing and one to count. Bautista, 0-1. Popped up to the pitcher, walked, stole a couple bases, and scored in the 3rd inning. Strike 1 to count. Runners with their leads, Peralta away from second. Next pitch swinging. There's a fly ball towards left field. Aldretti going back. He's there to make the catch. Now did he drop the ball? And so Jenks is going to go to third and step on third. Now they go to second. Double play. So the left fielder, Aldretti, dropped the ball. He had it in his glove, and the ball came out. And so the runners went back to their bases. So Aldretti throws the ball to Jenks. He goes to third, and then Rangel goes to second, and they get the force out at both bases for the double play. And no, actually it would be no, because you got two outs, so he never reached. So it goes 7-5-4 double play because you got two outs out of the deal. So a big break there for the Nitros as it goes 7-5-4 on the putout, and they get their double play. So for the Pirates, they do pick up a run, however. No hits, no errors, and actually, I guess nobody left on. So Aldretti, who had the ball in his glove, then dropped it. And the base runners, Peralta had to go back to second base, and Sanchez went back to first base. And so then Aldretti throws it to Jenks, who fires it to Rangel for the out, forcing Peralta out at third. And then Rangel throws a bullet down to Davin, covering second for the double play. And so the Nitro showing some baseball IQ there to get the outs and end the inning. So a run does come across, an unearned run. And we head to the fifth inning. 6-4 is the score with the Nitros on top coming to bat.
Thomas has thrown about 71 pitches now.
Yep. So he's gone, what, four innings? Yeah, it's getting up there. 70 pitches in four innings?
71.
70, let's see. So what is that? It's about 13 an inning.
Well, 20 would be 80.
Yeah, so about, no, 13 times 4. Maybe, what is that? So 17, more like 17. Yeah, that's a lot.
So that's not a lot, right?
Yeah, 17 an inning's a lot.
It's a lot?
It's a lot. Yeah, it's way too much. All right, so we head to the fifth inning. So Koverek threw four innings, two strikeouts, six walks, four runs, only three of them earned on two hits. And now you've got Trent Lucerarian leading things off for the Nitros. And the pitch is in there for a strike, facing a new pitcher, number 13. And we figured that would be the case when you had Peralta coming to pinch hit in Olguin's spot. Here's the next pitch on the way to Trent. Swinging. There's a fly ball towards right field. The right fielder, Medina, makes a diving attempt. Can't come up with it. The ball's going to get away from him. That allows Trent on his way to second. And Trent will lead things off with a double. So Trent with back-to-back hits opens up the fourth inning with a single, starts the fifth inning with a double, and he's got his first extra base hit of the season, I do believe. And you've got Mendez, number 13, pitching. So Robert Mendez, who is at third base, now pitching. And so I wonder if that means Peralta is at third base. And now they'll have to tend to the right fielder, Medina, who might have gotten the wind knocked out of him on that diving attempt. So we'll have to see who plays third when they get back to their defensive positioning. So for Trent, a two-hit ball game. His first extra base hit, had two hits against Desert Christian. Now two hits here against Paramount, coming out of that slump. And now let's see if the Nitros can cash him in again. Nitros have had the leadoff hitter aboard now in every inning, and they've scored him so far in two. In the second inning, Cole was thrown out 2-6 at second base trying to steal, caught stealing. And then in the third inning, Nord, who was running for Koverek, who reached on a walk, was caught in that 5-4-3 double play. But Davin, who opened the game with a walk, scored. And Trent, who opened the fourth inning, last inning, with a single, scored. Now he's on at second for Mike Titchener, who's 1-for-2 with a single and a run scored in that fourth inning. And it is Peralta at third base. Pickoff moved to second. Trent back to the bag. Trent with his lead away from second. Mike swings. There's a fly ball into right field. That's a base hit in front of Medina. Trent will move up 90 feet to third and stop there. And for the Nitros, they've got runners at the corners. So back-to-back hits, just like last inning for Trent and Titchener. And we've got runners at the corners for Adrian Cole. Angel Peralta is at third. So now Cole up there with runners at the corner, 6-4 in the fifth inning. Let's see if Titchener goes from first with a runner at third. There he goes, and they've got him picked off. The first baseman, Poot, throws down to the shortstop. Bautista, who was off the bag on the infield grass, thinking that maybe Trent was going to try to come home, he cuts it off. And so for Titchener, he gets a stolen base and ends up at second. So the Pirates, thinking that the Nitros were going to try to send home Trent, cut off the throw. But instead, Trent stays, and now you've got runners at second and third, the infield drawn in, and here's the pitch on the way. Missing outside, ball one. So Robert Mendez comes in here to take over on the mound for the Pirates into the fifth inning, and he's in a jam. Runners at second and third with nobody out. The next pitch, taken inside to Cole, 2-0. So Mendez, he has one appearance. He has an ERA of 7. He's pitched in 2 innings, just a sophomore. A 2-0 pitch in there for a strike. So Mendez, 2 innings pitched. He's given up 2 earned runs, 3 runs overall on 4 hits. He's walked a guy, faced 12 batters. Here's the 2-1 pitch to Cole. Taken just high, ball 3. 3 balls, 1 strike, the count on deck. The leadoff hitter, Davin Edom. Here's the 3-1. That's taken for... No, it's ball 4. What's Cole doing? Wow. He's like had ball 4, and then he started coming back to home plate. And he actually draws the walk. And so Mendez offers up his first walk after giving up back-to-back hits. I guess he had to call timeout, wait for Cole to get to first base. Yeah, you have to wait till the runner technically gets to first base, and then the umpire calls timeout because the ball is still technically live until the guy gets to first base. Because the other runners could, in theory, do something. So the bases are loaded. You've got Trent at third. You've got Titchener at second. You've got Cole at first. Davin at the plate. He doubled, driving in all 3 of them last inning to put the Nitros up at the time 6-3. Nitros with 2 in the first, 4 in the fourth. The Pirates with 2 in the second, 1 in the third, and 1 in the fourth. 6-4, we're in the fifth inning. Davin 1-for-2, doubled, drove in 3 and scored a run, and he takes a pitch, curveball over for strike 1. He also walked and scored in the first inning and flew out to center field in the second. So Mendez working from the windup with the bases loaded. Deals the next pitch in there for strike 2. So a curveball and a fastball, and Davin down in the count now, nothing and 2. So nothing and 2 the count. Mendez is ready and deals on the pitch. Breaking ball, checks his swing. It's ball 1. 1 ball, 2 strikes the count. Infield drawn in with the bases loaded. Outfield playing pretty much straight away. Mendez with a little pop on his pitch now steps off and requests time. Now it's back up on the mound. Runners with their leads from the windup. The 1-2 pitch. Low and away with a fastball, and the count goes 2-2. So two balls and two strikes the count. Nobody out. Bases loaded. We're in the fifth. 6-4 is the score. Here's the 2-2 offering. Breaking ball low and away, and the count goes 3-2. So a full count, nobody out. And the bases, base runners aren't going to be going necessarily because with nobody out, you don't want to get a double play here. And here's the payoff pitch. Ball four just off the mark outside, and Davin draws the rock. That brings home Trent, and that makes it 7-4. He had him 0-2, two, and threw him four straight balls. And Davin picks up the RBI, his second walk of the game. Second walk offered up by Mendez. And that brings up Nolan Wong with the bases loaded and nobody out. Swings at the first pitch and fouls it off. Strike one, the count. So Wong last time at bat, he singled, drove home Davin. And then he's walked the time both times before that. So he's 1-for-1 with two walks, a single, an RBI and a run score. Takes a pitch on the outside corner for strike two. And now, just like Davin, Wong down in the count, nothing and two. So let's see how Mendez battles back after going 0-2 to Davin through four straight balls. And there's ball one to Wong. One ball, two strikes the count. 7-4 is the score. Nitro's on top here in the fifth inning. Here's the next pitch. Swinging, fouled it at the plate, so Wong gets a piece of it, stays alive. And the count remains 1-2. On deck, Darian Jenks. So the Nitros, with nobody out, a run across, and the base is loaded, chance to really break this thing open here. Here's the 1-2. Taken high, ball two. 2-2 the count. Again, the infield drawn in means they're playing on the infield grass instead of normal depth. The 2-2 pitch, swinging, poked foul over the third base dugout, out of play toward the football field, and the count goes to 2-2. Mendez, the third pitcher for the Pirates. Olguin started, gave way to Reyes, and now Mendez. Here's the 2-2 offering. Breaking ball swinging. There's a ground ball towards second. Nice backhand by the second baseman Sanchez coming home for the out, forcing Titchener at the plate. And you've got one down. Nice backhanded play there by Sanchez. Wong reaches on the fielder's choice. 4-2 on the putout. Cole advances to third, Davin to second. Wong at first for Darian Jenks. He's 0-for-3. Fouled out to the catcher. Grounded out to third and flew out to center field. And takes the first pitch, a breaking ball outside, ball one. Jenks, a right-handed hitter, up against Mendez, the right-handed pitcher. Here's the 1-0 pitch. Low and away, ball two, 2-0. So you've got one out in the inning. 2-0 the count. Hitter's count here. See if he throws dead red fastball. Throws the fastball, but misses ball three. 3-0, and now you're in a taking situation. As a walk brings home a run, and now the pitcher Mendez will take a stroll back behind the mound. Collect his thoughts and see what pitch to come up with. It's got to be a strike or he gives up a run. And there it is, strike one. Three balls, one strike to count. Cole down the line of third. Davin at second. Wong at first. Jenk swings and misses. And actually, again, Nord back at first running. Don't want to neglect him, his prime time appearance. Full count. Jenk swings and misses, and down he goes. So Mendez picks up his first strikeout. It's the second strikeout for the Nitros, the other one belonging to Trent. And that brings up, I guess, Joel Leon batting for Kavorik. So it looks like Kavorik's day is done. We'll see who comes in to pitch, as Leon is the pinch hitter now. So Kovarik ends up going 0 for 2 with a walk. And the first pitch to Joel on the outside corner to the left-handed hitter. Strike one, the count. Coming into the contest, as the next pitch is outside for a ball, he's hitting a buck 90. He's 4 for 21, has 4 singles, 3 RBI, an on-base percentage of 320. A little bit of a slump himself, so maybe an opportunity here for him to break out of that slump. Takes the next pitch over at the knees for strike two. So 1-2 the count. Breaking ball high and tight, and the count runs 2-2 to Joel. So now Mendez, a pitch away from getting out of it. The only run he'd give up is that walk to Davin that drove in Trent. Next pitch is ball three, as some of the Pirates were thinking it would be strike three, started heading off the field, and the count runs full. So with three balls, two strikes, two outs, the runner's going with the bases loaded. And there's strike three right down Broadway. So Leon strikes out, second strikeout from Mendez. The Nitros, though, they do pick up a run. They do that on two hits, and they leave the bases loaded. They've left nine men on through five innings. They did pick up a run, though, to extend the lead 7-4. We're back with the bottom of the fifth right after this. Really? It says 63 degrees. Feels colder than that. Feels like it's in the 50s. Anyways, we head to the bottom of the fifth inning. Darian Jenks coming in to pitch for the Nitros. So Kovarik goes four innings, striking out two, walking six, allowing four runs, only three earned on two hits. And so for Jenks, he comes into the contest with a 1-0 record, an ERA of .66. He's pitched in 10 and 2-thirds innings, striking out 16, walking 4, allowing a run on two hits and hitting one batter. So 1-0 with an ERA of .66. Got the victory in against Monroe in that walk-off fashion. And Davin got the base hit, driving in the run that ended that game. So Davin moves to short, and Ryan Kataoka goes into second base, and the first pitch to Mendez in there for a strike. So Mendez, who just got off the mound, will now try to get things going for his team and help his cause. Next pitch from Jenks, taken low and away, one ball, one strike the count. Jenks, last pitch against Foothill Tech, he went two innings, striking out three. Like I said, got the win against Monroe, striking out eight in four innings, breaking ball, missing outside. And then went 4 2/3 innings against Arleta, striking out five. So two balls, one strike to count. Next pitch from Mendez to Mendez is in there for strike two, 2-2. Mendez 0 for 2, fouled out to Rangel at third and then popped up to Davin at second. Two balls, two strikes to count. Jenks, a junior, into his windup and the pitch swinging. There's a fly ball towards center field. Cole coming over, makes the catch, and we've got one down. And so Mendez retired for the third consecutive time. One away in the inning, and that brings up Raimundo Medina. He's 0 for 1. Popped up to the first baseman to end the first and then walked and was thrown out on the 2-5-6-1 rundown in the third inning. Right-handed batter, and he gets hit by the pitch. And for Jenks, that is the second hit batter this year for him. Hit a batter in that Monroe game. That brings up Michael Poot. Poot, the left-handed hitter, he is 1 for 2. He singled, drove in a run back in the third inning, and then grounded out to first. So Trent holding the runner on as the pitch is taken low, ball one. So Medina at first base, 7-4, bottom of the fifth inning. On deck is Omar Padilla. So Jenks working from the stretch. Is ready and deals, showing bunt, taken for a strike. And that evens up the count at a ball and a strike. So the Pirates down by three here in the fifth inning. They've got one out, runner at first. The infield looking to turn two and get out of it. Jenks from the stretch, sets, throws to first, not in time. Remember, they ended last inning with that 7-5-4 double play. It was a fly ball out to Aldretti in left, had it in his glove, but then I guess dropped it. The runners had to retreat thinking the ball was caught, and then they threw it around the horn and got the double play. Throw to first, not in time. And I guess technically you could go 7-6-5-4 because it went to the relay Jenks. Went to the third baseman, then to the second baseman, but that's just too many numbers. So one ball, one strike to count. Medina taking his lead away from first, being held on there by Trent. Poot at the plate awaits the pitch. Taken low, ball two. Two balls, one strike to count. So now the Pirates trying to get something going, and their dugout trying to encourage their team on. Making some noise, as they say. Here's the 2-1 offering. There goes the runner. The pitch swung on and fouled off. And so the count goes to two balls and two strikes. The Pirates picking up two in the second, one in the third, and one in the fourth. After they went down in order in the first inning, they've scored in each inning since. Much like yesterday with San Dimas, they went down in order in the first, and then they got a bunch of runs each inning after that on their way to a 10-0 victory. Here's the pitch. Swinging, that is fouled off. Third base side, back out of play, and the count remains 2-2. Nitro's picking up two in the first, and then they got four in the fourth and one in the fifth. And that's where we stand here in the bottom of the fifth inning. Jenks up on the mound now, giving way or taking over for Kovarik, looking to perhaps get the save. Here's the 2-2, and that hits some. So back-to-back hit batters. We'll put runners on at first and second. Now Coach Chan heading to the mound to talk to his pitcher and to calm him down. That brings up Omar Padilla. He's walked twice, scored a run back in the second, and then walked and was left at first in the third inning. So So now let's see what the Nitros can do defensively. See if they can get out of this without giving up any runs. There is one out. Medina at second, Poot at first. Both men getting hit by a pitch. And for Jenks, that's the second and third batters he's hit on the season. So Midland fielders looking to turn to. Rangel in on the grass at third. Trent, even with the bag at first, the pitch to the plate, low and away, ball one. 1-0 the count. Burgos on deck. He's been the victim of two strikeouts, caught looking both times. So if Jenks can get Padilla here, it would help his cause. Here's the 1-0. Taken low, ball two. 2-0. 8 free passes on the night for the Nitros pitching staff. 6 walks and 2 hit batters. It's kind of been an issue, giving up too many freebies. Ball three to the backstop, and that will advance the runners. Medina goes to third. Poot goes to second. 3-0 count, and Jenks a pitch away from walking the bases loaded. So 3 balls and no strikes to count. Jenks making his way back up on the mound. Infield going to play back and try to get the out and concede the run. Showing bunt, the pitch is taken for a strike. A token strike, usually if you get it any place close. Umpire is going to call it a strike. So now it's 3-1. Yeah, facebook.com/EdenRocksRadio.com. Yeah, it's Facebook. The pitch swung on, fouled off, and the count runs full, 3-2. Or she can just... Yeah. Yeah. Might even be able to put Edom Rocks Radio, too, because I think I tried to get a nickname, so to speak, for it. So 3 balls, 2 strikes, 1 out. Padilla at the plate. See if Jenks can come up with a pitch here and get him. Here's the payoff pitch. Swung on and missed, and down he goes. So he does come up with a big pitch. Gets Padilla to strike out. We've got 2 away, and that brings up Joshua Burgos. He's 0 for 2 with 2 strikeouts, unless we get a pinch hitter here. And it looks like we're going to get a pinch hitter, number 12, coming in for the Pirates. And that is Collins. So Isaiah Collins now batting in place of Burgos, who went 0 for 2 with 2 strikeouts. Collins on the season, a .250 hitter. He has 1 hit and a run scored in 4 games. On the pitch. Which ones? Oh, for the other two, Burgos? Or Collins now with a strike one count. Swinging and missing.
Well, I guess it was 4 pitchers on the second strikeout. That's right, 1 ball was involved.
The next pitch swung on and missed, strike 2. Down in the count now, nothing and 2.
So it was
7 pitches.
On 3
Jenks might get this guy on 3 pitches. Collins, again, a .250 hitter. Had his lone hit against Murrieta Valley. He struck out twice against CV on Saturday, St. Patrick's Day. There's the 0-2. Swung on and missed, and down he goes. So Jenks able to get out of it with back-to-back strikeouts. No runs, no hits, 2 hit batters, no errors, and 2 men left on. At the end of 5, 7-4. Nitro's on top. We're back after this.
Sometimes I dream that he is me. Got to see, that's how I dream to be.
I dream I move.
I move.
I dream I prove. Like Mike, if I could be like Mike.
I wanna be like Mike.
Like Mike, if I could be like Mike.
I could be like Mike.
Be like Mike.
Oh.
So back here as we head to the sixth inning, 7-4 is the score. The Pirates on top. Son Edom with you, along with Stuart Edom from Paramount High School, the Green Cathedral here at Paramount. Mendez coming out for a second full inning of work for the Pirates, facing Ethan Aldretti, who's 1-for-2 with a single, a walk, and an RBI, and he takes the first pitch high, ball one. A lot of pitches thrown. We mentioned Kovarik had 71 pitches in his four innings. Next pitch in there for a strike to Aldretti, one ball, one strike the count. So he walked and drove in a run in the first inning, or check that, he singled and drove in a run in the first inning, flew out to center field in the third. Here he sends a ground ball to second. Sanchez with it, goes to first in time, and we've got one down. 4-3 on the putout. He walked his last at-bat and was stranded at first. The Nitros, 7 runs on 7 hits, and they've also left 9 men on. 9 men on. Nate Rangel swinging at the first pitch, sends a high fly ball into center field. Going back on it is Burgos. He's there to make the catch and quickly 2 away. So he gave it a ride to deep center, the deepest part of the ballpark. And we've got 2 outs. And Trent Lucerarian up. Singled and doubled. Struck out, scored twice. Struck out in the first. He singled in the fourth, doubled in the fifth. Does he have the wheels for a triple? It's a vast outfield. Swing and a miss. Strike one, the count. So Trent with a good game at the plate. Looking to start maybe a 2-out rally. Next pitch catches the corner on the outside part of the plate. Strike two. Down in the count now, nothing and two. And for Mendez, looking to make quick work of the Nitros here in the sixth inning. Here's the 0-2 pitch. Taken high. That hits everybody. It's off the catcher's glove, off the top of the head of the umpire to the backstop. Now the catcher will go out to talk to the pitcher and give the umpire a chance to shake it off. Some umpires wear the soft baseball cap with the mask. Others will wear the hockey-style mask with the whole headgear, like some catchers do, like the catcher that we have right now is wearing that. This umpire wearing the soft caps, when it goes off your noggin, it's going to sting a little. So 1-ball, 2-strikes the count to Trent. On deck, Mike Titchener. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Breaking ball, strike three called, and down goes Trent. So he strikes out for the second time tonight. The Nitro's gone in order. We head to the bottom of the sixth, 7-4. Nitro's on top. We're back after this. Makes me feel good, makes me feel nice. Have a Coke and a smile, that's the way it should be. I like to see the whole world smiling with me. Coca-Cola and Sprite, have a Coke and a smile. A Coke and a smile, to a guy, light up the DJ on me. Turn on the sun.
I drink Dr. Pepper and I'm proud. I used to be alone in a crowd, but now you look around these days, there seems to be a Dr. Pepper craze. I'm a pepper, he's a pepper, she's a pepper, we're a pepper, wouldn't you like to be a pepper too? I'm a pepper, he's a pepper, she's a pepper, if you drink Dr. Pepper, you're a pepper too. Us peppers are an interesting breed, an original taste is what we need. Ask any pepper and he'll say, only Dr. Pepper tastes that way. I'm a pepper, he's a pepper, she's a pepper, we're a pepper, wouldn't you like to be a pepper too? I'm a pepper, he's a pepper, she's a pepper, we're a pepper, wouldn't you like to be a pepper too? Be a pepper, drink Dr. Pepper.
Come on.
Be a pepper, drink Dr. Pepper.
Right.
Be a pepper, drink Dr. Pepper.
So we head to the bottom of the sixth inning. Nitro's lead at 7-4, and due up for the Pirates, you've got Rivera, Peralta, and Sanchez, 7, 8, and 9 in their lineup. Jenks out for a second full inning of work. He has two strikeouts and two hit batters.
They already put zero up there for this inning.
Well, I think they've been doing that. And then they switch it when a run comes across. They always put the zero up before the inning. Yep. So Rivera reached on an error and scored back in the fourth inning. He walked and scored in the second, so he's gotten on both times, and he scored both times, and he takes a pitch low, ball one. Jenks, like I said, out for a second full inning of work and relief. He got Mendez to fly out, a couple hit batters after Mendez, and then two strikeouts to end last inning. Next pitch, off the mark, a bit high. Ball pops out of Wong's glove. 2-0 the count. Again, Rivera, 333 hitter. Two hits against Sunny Hills, two hits against Long Beach Pauley. A couple multi-hit games, takes a breaking ball for a strike on the outside part of the plate, down around the knees. And then he had a hit also against Yucaipa. That's three strikeouts on the season. That walk was his second walk of the season that he got earlier in this game. Takes ball three down low. Three balls, one strike to count. Raider Peralta on deck. Jenks working from the windup is ready and deals. And there's a one hopper towards Kataoka at second. Goes to first in time, and we've got one down. 4-3 on the putout. That's what Ethan did in the top of the sixth inning for the Nitros. Ground ball to second. So then Rangel flew out to center field. So let's see if the Pirates play copycat. And if they do, Peralta will fly out to center field here.
Here's the hard
hitter. Yeah, this is the guy that was hitting the ball hard everywhere except between the lines where it counted. He ended up drawing a walk. And the pitch taken for ball one. 1-0 the count. So Peralta, who walked in his last at-bat, took over for the pitcher Gabriel Olguin, who doubled home two in the first or in the second inning that got them their first two runs. Next pitch, over for a strike. 1-1 the count. Nitro's looking for their third win of the season. That would surpass what they did last year. They went 2-21-1 last year, and then the year before that, they won four games. So they could be setting themselves up for a year, unlike the last couple. Next pitch over for strike two. And as these younger players mature, the way Pacific League is, you know, you win a few ball games, you're right there. Here's the 1-2 pitch. That goes to the moon. 2-2. If you think about it, Hoover, they don't have a JV team. Their team is really down. They have one win on the season. Can't assume anything. Last year, the Nitros lost twice to Muir and twice to Hoover. They went 0-4 against those teams for the first time in a long time. There's ball three, full count. What? I don't know. I think Glendale T-ball. Three balls, two strikes to count. Swinging, fouls it back. But the point is that, you know, you've got Muir, who's up and coming. They're not gimmies anymore. Like I said, Hoover beat the Nitros twice last year. They're not gimmies anymore. But you look at the preseason, like this team here beat Pasadena yesterday 3-2, held CV to 5-2. That's why you play the games. I mean, look at, you know, March Madness. Everybody's bracket is busted because you got to play the games. There's a comebacker to Jenks falling down. He picks it up on the mound, throws to first over to Trent, and we've got two away. Nice play by Jenks. 1-3 on the putout. We've got two away. And that brings up the number nine hitter, Edgar Sanchez. He is 0-2. He hit it back to the pitcher both times. So, again, you've got to play these games. And so, you know, right now Arcadia in their non-league preseason here is 7-0 on the season. They could be the team to beat this year. Here's the pitch. Fastball taken high, ball one. It's been a number of years since Arcadia. Thanks, Valerie, for that compliment. But it's been a number of years since I think Arcadia has won a league championship as the pitch is fouled off. It's been pretty much CV, and then I think Burroughs, perhaps. But Arcadia, it's been a number of years. So one ball, one strike, the count. Sanchez at the plate, hitting back to the box a couple times. Jenks looking to shut them down here and get out of the sixth inning. Swung on and missed. Strike two, a ball and two strikes, the count. On deck, the leadoff hitter, Adrian Bautista. Jenks looking to get out of it right here. One ball, two strikes, the count. The pitch swung on. It's a fly ball towards short. Back on the outfield grass, Davin is there to make the catch, and the inning comes to a close. So at least this time, Sanchez got to be on the pitcher. And he flies out to the shortstop in shallow left field. So the Pirates, they're gone in order. No runs, no hits, no errors. Or like the old spray paint commercial with Johnny Bench, no runs, no drips, no errors. We head to the seventh. It's 7-4. Nitro's on top. We're back after this. So the first pitch here in the seventh inning, Jesus Vasquez batting, swings and fouls it off, strike one the count. So Vasquez hitting for Titchener, and then Titchener will re-enter for defensive purposes. Here's the next pitch, taken for strike two, down in the count, nothing and two. He had a walk against Arleta and then went 0-for-1 against Canyon. So he has an on-base percentage of .500, the senior. I think this is his first year in the program, too, as a senior. Mendez out for his third inning of work. Swing and a miss, and down goes Jesus. So the third strikeout for Mendez, and that will now bring up Seth Harley, who's going to bat for Cole, and then Cole will re-enter, I was told, for defensive purposes. Harley wearing number 14, takes a pitch in there for a strike. Nothing and one the count. Harley on the season, hitting .125. He's 2-for-8, two singles, four walks, a run scored. Swing and a miss at the next pitch, down in the count, nothing and two. He does have an on-base percentage, though, of .500, 6-for-12, but right now he's down in the count, nothing and two. And Mendez deals strike three, and he makes quick work of Harley. So is that six straight pitches?
Yep.
And we've got two strikeouts. And that brings up Davin, the leadoff hitter. He's 1-for-2. He has two walks. He had the double, bases clearing double that drove in three. So he has two walks, a double, four RBI, and two runs scored, and a couple stolen bases, and he takes a pitch outside, ball one. 1-0 the count. 14 stolen bases on the season for the leadoff hitter. Mendez is ready and deals on the breaking ball. Taken high, ball two. 2-0 the count. 7-4 in the seventh. Nitro's looking for the third victory of the season, looking to snap a couple-game losing streak. There's a strike. Two balls, one strike the count. Again, the next game is scheduled for tomorrow at noon versus Summit at Glendale High School. Next pitch, fastball in there, strike two. And again, it will depend on the rain, as the rain is supposed to come in, but we will see. Two balls, two strikes, two outs, top of the seventh inning. Mendez is ready and deals, and the pitch in the dirt, ball three, and the count runs full, three balls and two strikes. Ian Nord on deck. Might get an opportunity to bat here. Damon gets aboard. Here comes the payoff pitch from Mendez. Swinging, there's a fly ball towards center field. The center fielder, though, is there. Burgos makes the catch, and for the second time, Damon flies out to center field, and that will end the inning. So the Nitros go down in order in the seventh. No runs, no hits, no errors, nobody left on. We head to the bottom of the seventh inning. Time for the Nitros to get three outs before they give up three runs and they get the victory. We'll see if they can do that right after this.
Sometimes I dream that he is me. Got to see that's how I dream to be.
All right, so we head to the bottom of the seventh, and Davin back in at short, still in at short, I should say, and you've got basically the infield still the same. Rangel at third, Davin at short. You've got Kataoka at second, Trent at first. You've got Wong behind the plate. You've got Cole back in center field, Titchener back in right field, and Aldretti in left field. So Jenks looking to close it out, pick up the save, the pitch over for a strike. He's got Bautista, Mendez, and Medina, the top of the lineup. Bautista in his last at-bat hit into the 7-5-4 double play. And the pitch from Jenks is taken low, ball one. One ball, one strike the count. He is 0-for-2 with a walk, Bautista, the leadoff hitter. Here's the pitch. Swinging. There's a ground ball to Davin at short. He's up with it. Throws to first in time. And we've got one down. 6-3 on the putout. And that brings up Robert Mendez. He's 0-for-3. So your first two batters, 0-for-6 with a walk and a run scored. It's not usually going to get the job done. Although then you go down to the bottom of the lineup and they've got some production out of the bottom of the lineup. So I guess it just depends. Here's the pitch. In there for a strike to Mendez, who is the relief pitcher, the third pitcher to take the mound for the Pirates here tonight. Nothing in one the count. So Jenks looking to pick up his first save and give Thomas his first victory. And the pitch is in the dirt. Ball one. One ball, one strike the count. Coming up after the game, we're going to try to get some comments from the team, but they usually go off to the outfield and chat and take some forever to get over here. But we'll see if we can snag an interview or two. Also got to make sure they don't turn the power off on us. There's a fly ball towards right field. Titchener is there, and he makes the catch, fading toward the line, and the Nitros are one out away from the victory. And so Mendez ends his night 0-for-4, and that brings up Raimundo Medina. He was hit by a pitch and stranded at third in his last at-bat. He walked and was thrown out at third, back in the third, and then he ended the first inning, popping up to Trent at first base. Nitro's on top, 7-4, looking for the third victory of the season. And the pitch in there for a strike. Nothing and one the count. So they went 2-2 to start the season. Then they had a tie and two losses since then. Next pitch, big cut, swung on and missed. Now the Nitros a strike away from picking up the victory. So Jenks looking to close it out. He had a rough day at the plate, but they'll trade it in for that good night on the mound that he's having. And the pitch swung on and fouled back, so the Pirates still alive. So the Nitros did not get to play this game last year. It got rained out. So they meet again this year, and the rain stayed away for the 6 o'clock start game. And they're a pitch away from getting the victory. Nothing and two the count. Here's the 0-2 offering. Pitch taken high, ball one. And the next game scheduled for tomorrow at noon Pacific time, but again, with the rain coming in, it's hard to say if they're going to get the game in or not. Here's the 1-2 pitch. There it is. Taken inside, 2-2. Close pitch, almost like it's too close to take. It's like that thing, two strikes, swing at anything close. So two balls, two strikes to count. Jenks is ready, and he deals. And the pitch, strike three called, and that's the ball game. So Jenks comes in, retires the side in order, and outside of hitting two batters, he goes fifth, sixth, and seventh inning without giving up a hit, a run, and only two hit batters, and he gets the save. Thomas Kovarik gets the victory, his first win of the season, his first varsity win at Glendale High School. He's 1-0 on the year. Jenks has a save. And so for Kovarik, he goes four innings, striking out two, walking six, allowing four runs, three of them earned on two hits. And then Jenks goes two innings, striking out three and hitting two batters. So the Nitros improved to 3-4-1 on the season.